What's up, YouTube? Soulfate here with Clifftongasium, BaneRain, and Tyki, and we're bringing you guys another episode of the Hitmonchat. We got a lot to talk about today. We got all the tier changes in Smogon, the black and white 2 upgrades. We have a very special announcement about the PU tourney and the PFC server, and we're going to talk about some Gen 6 predictions. So, that said, why don't we say hello to everyone? So, hello, Cliff, Bane, and Tyki.
Not even a minute in, and he's already interrupting someone. We're not even in the content of the Hitmonchat yet. Like, he's introducing everyone, and you managed to interrupt him.
Just you guys don't know, I have a very bad habit, along with Antonio, of interrupting people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. So let's try it again. Tyki?
Say hi.
Hi.
Bane, say hi.
Hello.
Cliff, say hi.
This is the first time I've spoken in this podcast. That is a first.
Yeah. All right. Okay, so, hi. Yeah. So let's get down to business. So the black and white 2 upgrades, they brought out a lot of tier changes.
That's got nothing to do with black and white 2 coming up. That's just the usage tier changes.
Yeah, that too. So I guess we should start with PU. So we'll talk to Bane a bit about that since he's the expert there.
Sure. What do you want to ask me?
The tier changes.
The tier changes. All right. Well, I happen to have this Pirate Pad conveniently opened up on my internet browser. Totally unrelated to the fact that we're doing a podcast. But...
and I happen to have linked you all the tier changes in the Skype.
Yeah, they're in the chat.
Well, I have them on my Pirate Pad, so suck it.
Okay.
Anyway, all right. So as you guys all know by now, I've been doing a lot of PU stuff. I've been sort of the go-to guy without wanting to honk my own horn. I've become very good at it too.
Whoa. You missing up an opportunity to honk your own horn.
Okay, fine. Honk. God damn it.
Oh my god.
Anyway, that's the thing. So the tier has sort of been turned on its head. Obviously, the metagame isn't changing too much. There's a few new contenders. The last tier's change, this is actually kind of unfortunate because I think the tier change is like the reason these things went up is a result of people using the PU on the like probably us, actually.
Sorry about that.
So you sort of except Metang. Metang's like stupid. I don't really know how it went to RU. But anyway, needless to say, the Destroika went to NU, which didn't really surprise me to be honest, because it's still used somewhat frequently on NU teams. Gigalith did as well. Piloswine did as well. I think that's because Piloswine got thick fat. So, it's more viable as a tank now. Lapras went up. I think that's mainly just PU. Electabuzz went up. Definitely PU. Kangaskhan went up. Either ELO fanboys or PU. And, like I said, Metang went to RU. So, Jesus Christ. So those things are gone.
Can I just point out you meant to swallow cereal, not inhale it?
Yeah. No, I like just sort of stick my lips in the bowl and I go... Anyway. Some new stuff came down, though. I think it might actually be correlated to Electabuzz moving up and Zebstrika moving up. More people used those and they didn't use these. So we have 3 new electric types that came down. 2 of which that are probably going to go back up because, like, come on. And these are Raichu, Luxray, Leafeon... Raichu, Luxray, and... Like, shut up! And Electros.
So Leafeon is a strong electric type, man.
Leafeon is, like, the best electric type in the game.
That
like,
stab like, Leaf Blade? Oh my god. And, like, the 30% chance of paralysis?
Electric terror, dude. Unlike its counterpart, its grass counterpart, Jolteon.
Yep.
Glaceon.
Said on the internet is 100% true. Remember that, guys.
Glaceon's a fire type. What are you talking about?
Of course.
Yeah.
Dumbass.
Jeez, Tyki, are you high, bro?
Maybe.
Interrupt everyone. At least know what you're talking about. So those things came down. I think Raichu,
to be honest, fills the role of Electabuzz and Zebstrika, because it's about as fast as Electabuzz. I think a little bit slower, and a little bit more capable offensively.
And it gets E-Speed.
Yeah, so it's basically Zebstrika and Electabuzz combined, right? Because it gets the Lightning Rod from Zebstrika, and it can be like, you know, it has the power sort of Electabuzz. I don't know, but anyway, I think it works fine, right? That's no problem there.
My only really problem with it, comparing to Electabuzz, is it is unable to utilize Violate if you want to win like a somewhat bulky set. But that's like a really minor difference because no one runs bulky Electabuzz.
If it's gonna fill the position that Electabuzz and Zebstrika had, then it's usually gonna be scarfed anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I don't think that's too much of a problem. All right, Luxray, that big 120, I think, attack, which is already obscenely high for PU.
With a Guts.
Doesn't that also get Guts? Yeah.
Yeah, and it also gets Guts. How do you get it sharp? And it just, I don't know. It seems to me like it's a bit too strong, and its place isn't really there, to be honest. I mean, it's the third stage. It's got fairly high base stat total. It's got respectable speed for something in PU.
Is it the only third stage in PU at the moment?
Maybe, actually.
No, Meganium. Meganium.
Yeah, Meganium, Butterfree, Beedrill, there's a few of them. But, now, moving on, there's also Electros, which I don't agree with it being there at all, because it's strong. Coil sets, anything sets. You can run Coil Set with all the punches now, did you know that? You can run Coil, Zap Cannon, and like max special attack or something. Then you run Coil, Zap Cannon, and then like two punches for coverage or something, and you're pretty much set. But you can run all kinds of shit. Anyway, the point is it's really strong and it's really bulky and it has no place there.
Mm.
But so that's probably going to move back up. And another one that I think a lot of people have been ignoring so far is Duotion. Duotion is now PU. It moved down to NFE. So feel free to use that.
Hippopotas also moved down.
I'm gonna put that in right now.
But sand is also banned though, so yeah, it's just there as a wall.
You have to use sand force, but still, it's got pretty decent special physical defense stat within a Violite. Yeah, but I don't know if it.
You can run it as a Violite wall, but I think
Does it really feel the role that Sandshrew does better? Yeah, Sandshrew gets spin.
It's the same thing. It's the same thing as Phanpy. Phanpy is a better physical wall than Sandshrew, but unlike Donphan, it doesn't actually get rapid spin, so it's sort of useless.
Mm.
So Hippo also gets a slack off.
It does get slack off, so that's one advantage. But I mean, I suppose you could use it as a physical wall, but then you miss out on rocks. No, it's like, especially with rocks being as powerful as they are in PU.
Yeah, I was about to say, let's be honest, the two most powerful moves in PU are Stealth Rocks and Knock Off. And Sandshrew gets both. And Rapid Spin.
Does Hippo not get Knock Off?
It might do, actually.
I'm not going to check this.
It might. I doubt it, though, because it doesn't really have hands for it.
He's checking that. What about the stuff that left PU, Bane?
Well, I just talked about that.
Yeah, Bane would cover that. If we're going to go on to NU, there is one thing that Bane hasn't spoken about, because it came down from RU. And that's Golurk.
That's Golurk, yeah.
Oh, I'll let Tom take care of this, actually.
I'm kind of the only person that's actually abused Golurk at the moment, at least out of our slot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pretty much Golurk is the only thing that came down, nothing really big. I think a few things went up that were quite powerful in NU, which were Quagsire and Magmortar and Cryogonal. With Cryogonal going up, it's actually, I think, it's going to increase the usage stats for Regice, because they kind of did the same role, but Cryogonal sort of did it better.
And while I still have a chance, Hippopotas does not get knockoff.
Okay. But yeah, Golurk, I mean, what would you run? Life Orb, Rock Polish, Earthquake, Shadow Punch, and then Filler for coverage. I think I run Ice Punch. They don't quote me on it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, you can run Ice Punch, I'm pretty sure. But
other than all the PU stuff going up, which really kind of doesn't matter to like the main metagame of NU, because it was already usable in NU, obviously. Just Quagsire, Magmortar, Croagunel, Golurk. I suppose you can mention Metang.
Yeah, Metang went up. I don't really, to be honest, I haven't seen it used in RU, so I don't know why it just skyrocketed suddenly to RU. I don't really know where they're getting their stats for that. I mean, I know it's used a lot in NU, but I never saw it ever used in RU, so...
I was pretty shocked that it was in PU to begin with, because I used to see it a lot in NU.
Mm-hmm. Well, once again, it's usage, right? It's one of the flaws with Smogon, at least with lower tiers. I mean, now they're remedying it. Yeah. Go tell you, sorry.
Well, the thing is, like, I mean, if we're going into RU, Metang really... RU lacks a lot of good steel types. Like, there's Steelix, and there's, I mean...
Escavalier?
Isn't Magneton there?
Magneton there, yeah. Like, the Metang, it's just a great Pokemon in general. I mean, I don't think it should be RU personally. I think it should be NU, but...
Yeah.
As great as Lucario?
I think Lucario is the best Pokemon, and it should be above Uber.
It should be an unreleased.
Oh, Lucario is the only Lucario. Alright,
So are you? We might as well start talking about that.
So yeah. Are you? You guys probably know I'm mostly an LU player, but are you and LU are getting very similar now, especially with these new tier switches. So Nidoqueen and Escavalier are going down.
Yeah. Nidoqueen is an RU. What the fuck?
Yeah. So that also happened in LU, but I think the one that has the biggest what the fuck is Escavalier, which I believe a lot of people really criticized LU about. I'm like, oh, LU has Escavalier. It's not balanced.
Isn't it NU now, Escavalier? It moved down
it's
to NU.
It's now NU. That's stupid. It's stupid.
Well played, Pio. Well played.
Well played.
I'm just opening Pokemon Online now. Team Builder. Escavalier.
Okay.
So, Duotion. Trick Room. Okay, I'm done.
All right. So by the end of the podcast, Cliff, you should be at number one on the Pio NU ladder.
Probably.
Cliff's going to be laddering throughout this entire podcast just behind the team.
Yeah.
Yeah. So further into RU. Bane already said Quagsire, Cryogonal, Quagsire, Magmortar.
Thanks for calling me Bane.
You said that? I thought Bane said that.
No, that was me.
That was Cliff.
Oh, whoops.
We're the same person.
Similar, you know?
Yeah, you know, with my thick Londoner accent.
And my thick Canadian accent.
Hey, he's Quebecer.
All right.
There's a difference.
leave my scummy birthplace alone.
You bloody wanker.
Okay, back to Pokemon. So,
just start with the multiple. My bloody wanker. Anyway,
interrupting me. This is a change.
Karma.
I just want to interrupt for a moment and point out, in the 13 minutes we've been doing this podcast for, we covered more than the entire, like, half hour that me, Raven, and Bane covered in Raven.
Let's be fair, you and Raven, and then I came in, and I tried desperately to get you back on track, and then Raven was like, I'm Raven.
We were never on track to begin with, that's the thing. The podcast for that was literally just us derping about. But anyways, go ahead, Tyki.
Yeah, sorry, Tyki.
So, Escavalier dropping really is going to... Escavalier dropping is, like, really good for Magmortar coming up, because Escavalier, like, pretty much only dies if you use fire, because it's the RU scissor right now. It's also going to, like, really skyrocket the usage of the Trick Room teams. I know for one, I will be using it in a Trick Room team.
Slowking, bro. Slowking.
You'll be using it in NU. What are you fucking talking about?
You know what? I'm going to, like, use it in Smogon and get number one on the ladder. Fuck
there
you.
There isn't a Smogon anymore.
It's on ASM Showdown now.
We'll actually touch on that later. So,
yeah.
Okay.
We don't want to ruin the surprise.
Nidoqueen has two good sets. One of them is, like, the wall usually runs hazards. Normally Stealth Rock, though, can also do tap Toxic Spikes relatively well. And the attacker, which just abuses sheer force. So that thing's going to be a threat.
Doesn't that get Fire Blast?
It does get Fire Blast. It gets Earth Power, Sledge Wave, Fire Blast, Thunderbolt.
Ice Beam, Thunderbolt.
I said Thunderbolt.
Sorry.
But it's... I mean, that's already in a Scavalier check right there. Resisting Bug. Not resisting Steel, though, which is going to be a problem.
Quagsire's quite a good check for it.
Quagsire is an amazing check for it. The most common Scavalier set, I'd have to say, is Choice Band. It can run Swords Dance, but yeah. It's too slow to use it.
And Trick Room, you just waste a turn of Trick Room, so...
And you already waste a turn switching.
By the way, I have a gym leader Big Bang here who's asking me to become a mod. You know, it's like, well, you've been applied to the PFC, but you can't become a mod, so fuck you. Anyway.
The awkward moment if he watches this podcast.
I don't know. Like, if he manages to join the PFC and become a legit, fully-fledged PokeTuber, and, you know, get in with our gang and stuff, then, you know, he'll probably become a mod eventually, but it's not really something you just do overnight, so...
We should totally get matching leather jackets.
I was about to say
that.
Have, like, yes, Hitmonlee and Hitmonchan on the back of it, just duking it out again.
The funny thing about PFC, I think I've already mentioned this, but not on a podcast, is that in Quebec where I live, Kentucky Fried Chicken is French, is Poulet Frit Kentucky, so it's PFK. So every time I see PFC, it reminds me of Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Okay, and that's I'm not cool. going to make a joke there, because we are trying to keep it good.
Well, I know what we can just say. We'll just leave it at two words, Sour Boss, because his unboxing video is honestly the funniest thing I've ever seen, and if you haven't watched it, you should go and watch it. He did an unboxing video, yeah, and it was him unboxing a bucket of KFC.
Yeah,
it was hilarious.
Okay, so final notes of RU, we didn't lose anything. Next.
Well, you did. You lost Golurk. No, you didn't. Nothing went up.
I didn't.
Sorry.
All right, where's this...
It's in the chat.
Yeah, I'm looking. Shoot. Is it in the PFC chat or is it in
this
chat?
It's in this chat. UU,
Snover went down. Porygon Z went up.
Okay. Yeah, so I'll talk about UU for a bit here then. Because I've played it a couple times.
Like two times.
No.
Two things about UU that are really cool.
Scrafty and Mind Shell.
Yeah, Scrafty and Mind Shell in UU. And
you called that stupid on PL.
No, well, I called Scrafty stupid because I think Scrafty's kind of dumb in UU. But I was cool with Mind Shell down there.
Yeah, my chat doesn't really bother me, but Scrafty, it does.
Well, let's just talk about UU for a bit then. So, with the banning of Snow Warning and Sandstream from UU and below, and then they brought out Snover and Hippopotas' abilities from the Dream World, so you got Snover back from it. He dropped down from BL. Not too sure how long that's going to last. He'll probably drop down to NU.
He's going to come down to PU.
Yeah. He's going to just skyrocket right down. Porygon Zed came up from BL2, but he was already kind of UU anyway, so not going to touch too much on that. Scrafty from OU. Personally, I don't think that'll last very long. Scrafty is a fairly good Pokemon and can run a number of different sets, so...
I mean, it lasted on PO, so I don't know.
Well, seeing the Smogon switching over to Pokemon Showdown there, that I went over and played on there, and they literally whore everything out, so yeah. I can see that going straight back up. I can see a Scavalier going straight back up as well.
Mm-hmm. That's the
thing. Is a kick in the face, real quick. Mianshao doesn't get Ice Punch or any of the elemental punches, so...
It gets HP Ice, though.
Yeah, but...
If it got Ice Punch, it'd be so much better.
Dude, HP Ice, see, this is why HP Ice is actually better than Ice Punch, because HP Ice hits on the special side.
Right, yeah. You're actually right.
So for Gligar, it's actually better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Mian Shao will do well in UU because of that, because the HP Ice on the Gligar it'll pack quite a punch.
Plus Regenerator Core.
Yeah, of course, because Amoongus hasn't moved up to OU yet, hasn't he?
No.
No.
Slowbro, Amoongus, Menchao, just use all regenerate. I think, was it Tony who did the battle? No, I think it was Fade. Fade did, like, a mega regenerator thing.
Yeah, there's so many different regenerator cores you can run. Like, in OU, you can run Amoongus, Slowbro, and, Tornadus T.
I mean, fucking NU, you can run Amoongus and Almamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamolamol
with Regenerator. Alamola, too, is really annoying with Regenerator.
Not as annoying as Amoongus, though, because that thing gets...
No, that's true, that is true.
I mean, you can set up on Alamola, though, so...
It's good toxic stall poke, Alamola, with Wish.
Those are dollars going in this weird-ass fucking calm mindset. That you can't set up on. God damn it, that thing was so annoying.
Yeah.
After two calm minds, it's got like more special defense than defense, so it's like you can't hit it on either side. It just gets more frustrating.
That's like
I used it in OU with hydration.
Oh my god, you're such a dick. Fuck you, man. Honestly,
that's like when you take Cridilia and put it in OU with sand, and you get two curses up, and then nobody can touch you.
Yeah, except like Terrakion and anything with a fighting attack.
Yeah, you just run like rest, scald, calm mind, hidden power, grass. You're good.
It's okay.
Keep that thing away from me. Let's move up to. You nothing really happened, apart from Scrafty and Mindshell.
Yep. I don't think anything happened in OU other than like new.
Well, no. A Bomber Snow and Deoxys D went up from BL.
Okay. Well. Whatever.
And then we got some new toys.
Can I just point out, is Vulpix still BL? Because I'm pretty sure I didn't see Vulpix moving down to NFE.
No, it did move down to NFE, oh, but it moved down automatically because it was NFE, but it was just put up for BL because of Sun for some stupid reason that no one would run.
Mm. I was just wondering, I was really confused. Anyway, so but they're emptying out BL, if you've noticed. They're emptying out the BL tiers, this tier change.
Mm-hmm.
But I think other than the Abomasnow and Deoxys going up, all we can really talk about is Tornadus, Thunderous, and Landorus, Thorain, and Keldeo.
Yeah.
And Dash.
Oh my god. Yeah, so, a little bit of story behind that. When, me and Raven were recording the That Soul Raven podcast earlier today.
Talking about ponies the entire fucking time. It was awful.
Because Raven's a closet brony. Totally. He will never admit it, but I know. Anyways, so he makes the comment, like, we were talking about the title, and he was like, we should call it the That Soul Raven dash... whatever, I can't remember the last part of it. And I laugh because he makes himself sound like Rainbow Dash, which is one of the ponies on... Well, yeah. Not going to go into that.
You better fucking not go into that.
Anyways.
I think I just broke...
Yeah, it was funny at the time.
I think I just broke the swearing thing.
Oh. Yeah.
Was I the first guy to do that?
Titties, I don't know.
Yeah. All right, then I'm gonna go all out.
No, okay. Well, let's have some self-control here.
Yay! Aww. Also, Ubers.
Ubers. Chiron Black and Chiron White, but OU, Tornadus T, Monster Special Attack, Monster Speed stat, that thing.
I guess you can run mix.
He's gonna go.
Tornadus T is, in my opinion, the only good T form.
Whoa, are you saying Tornadus T is the only good T form? Thunderous T hits over 400 speed and special attack when it's scarfed.
Thunderous T is going ubers. Like, leave it at that.
Thunderous T is so powerful in the
lane. I go ubers just because... Actually, no, it's not. Never mind. Ubers is a ban list. It's not a...
Yeah, ubers is a ban list. Otherwise, Caesar would be up there.
Yeah.
Thing is, it doesn't really have any place...
Fortress would be up there.
Once you got things like Lightning Rod Zapdos and Volt Absorb Raikou running around,
Yeah, but still, HP Ice, Volt Switch, Thunder, and Focus Blast is actually really good coverage.
No, I know it's very good coverage, but I mean, you can't go for it. So the other guy has like a Zapdos. Thunder attack. You're stuck going for something else.
HP Ice.
Still, it's HP Ice. It's not like it's gonna. I don't know, man. It's I don't.
400 and
it's very good. I think it's very good, but it isn't ban worthy. You know.
Where, it's like, still it, ridiculously it is ban-worthy, powerful,
but not gonna get banned. Not so powerful as broken.
Do you think they're gonna retest Thunderous? When Lightning Rod Zapdos gets released.
Didn't they already retest Thunderous?
On PO, yeah.
I mean, I feel like they might, though I don't think they should.
The only thing about it was the Nasty Plot set was kind of OP.
Mm-hmm.
But then, Banded Mamoswine would take it out in one hit with an Ice Shard if I'm correct.
That's true. Yeah, Mamoswine.
No, not one hit.
I'm pretty sure it does at least plus 80. Plus 80%.
Okay, well, yeah, maybe, yeah. But I don't know. I'll check this right now, actually.
So, yeah, let's touch on that. Cliff, you got that new OU core that you've been using with
Banded Adamant? Or Banded...
Banded Adamant. That's what you do with Ice Shard.
Yeah, no, it's just checking. Okay.
I go Banded Quiet.
Your new core with Mamoswine and Venusaur.
My new core, yeah, Mamoswine core. It's just I've come to the conclusion that in
well, shit, it's been Oko. Damn it!
Told you. With Rain being so strong now because Thunderous, Tornadus, and Keldeo will come in all at the same time, plus the ridiculous amount of Rain stall. If you run a Sun team with Mamoswine and Venusaur, you kind of hard counter the Rain. I know you'd think, why would you run Mamoswine on a Sun team, but...
Mamoswine right now is the best metagame counter.
Exactly. Mamoswine is the only thing that you really fear. Terrakion.
Yeah.
Or Bullet Punch Banded Seizor.
So just slap a Gengar on the team, there you go.
Exactly.
But the Seizor, but...
Or a Gligar.
Yeah.
Did I say Gligar? Gliscor, sorry.
You said Gengar, but okay.
Shut up.
Shut up. Anyway, oh my god.
Shut up.
Okay, what were we talking about? We were talking about...
Mamoswine, Venusaur, Gengar, right. Core. Because... Yeah, obviously, or I mean, you could even use Gliscor on that if you wanted to, because Gliscor takes anything from Terrakion and Seizor.
Yeah, Blizzard can sort of eat bullet punches, doesn't really care. I was going to say another Steel type, but if you're on Sun team, you probably won't want to do that.
No, not with Mamoswine on there as well. I mean, Mamoswine on a Sun team is kind of illogical, but the only reason you have a Sun team is just because of Venusaur. Get that chlorophyll boost, and you know, Keldeo's shut down. Then
you have like an attachment with Venusaur in its entire evolutionary line.
Well, the attachment came originally from my first ever OU team was a Sun team with Venusaur, and then Bulbasaur's my favorite Pokemon, man. And then when we started the original testing of PU, we were looking for subseeders. No, I remember where the Ivysaur thing came from actually. We were laddering on Smogon. I think you were on this thing.
Yeah, we were making stupid-ass teams. Before PU was announced, we were just using, like, minimum usage NU and just seeing how high the ladder we could get to get on it.
And I was using Combusken with a Fire Gem workup set and Subseed Ivysaur. I think I was also using Rockhead Golem at the time without Head Smash or Double Edge. But and then I played Rick, Dangerous 36M, and I absolutely spanked him with it. And Ivysaur just controlled his team for the whole match, which is why my Ivysaur's called High Rick. Because if ever I'm using it and I play him, I want him to just see it and remember it. Because it was honestly such a... we were in a call at the time, weren't we? And there was like five of us in the call.
I think so, yeah.
And everybody came to watch the battle.
Yeah, it's pretty funny, actually. I remember that.
I'm not sure. Was I there when you...
No.
No,
you
I don't
there.
Think I was.
I think it was... Yeah.
AJ was there, I think.
Yeah, me, Bane, AJ, Croak, and Cole.
Antonio, too, maybe.
Yeah, maybe Antonio.
I think Antonio was there. I remember I was using a Vigoroth.
Yeah.
It was like bulk up, max special defense. I used it as my special wall. It was really funny.
Speaking of Ivysaur, I found that it is really broken. Like, I am not good at PU at all, and since I've started using Ivysaur, I've actually been able to win some battles. So
yeah, see, the one problem that I have with Ivysaur, it's not ban-worthy or anything, but the problem with Ivysaur is that it still, despite being a wall, it still hits relatively hard. And a lot of the hard, super effective things that hit Ivysaur on the physical side are either weak to grass, like, you know, the rock types or whatever.
And ground types.
Or, you know, they're just frail in general. They can't take attacks that well. So, you
and
know,
if the Ivysaur's got sub up.
Yeah. And the odds are that with a super effective attack, unless you got, since the offenses in PU aren't that astounding, they aren't, like, that impressive. It's normally a 2-hit KO, unless you got like banded and stab or something. Like, I'm not sure. I think from full rap dash will kill with like flare blitz one hit. It's fine. Maybe a dojo too. But if you don't have any of those or they're not out at the moment, you know, Ivysaur can sort of just set up a sub, leech seed. It can just ruin your day.
If you don't have a counter for it or a way to phase it, when that thing gets in,
the problem with phasing is that, you know, you can phase it, that's great, but...
If it's set up a leech seed on you, something comes in and it's getting leech seed recovery anyway.
Not only that, but, I mean, even... Look, if all you can do in an Ivysaur is phase it and you can't actually kill it, then once you're out of Pokemon, you only have an Ivysaur yet and they can't phase you anymore. You pretty much won.
Yeah, Ivysaur can control you, can control a game for you.
Yeah. It's great, you know? Good for Ivysaur, but,
mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's very strong.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I consider Ivysaur to have what I like to call Alakazam syndrome, where it is really, really, really good and really, really aggravating to kill, but it's not broken and not ban-worthy.
Yeah.
Or kind of like, sort of like Terrakion. It's really, really good and really strong. You can kind of stop it. Well, with Terrakion, you can kind of stop it, but it's kind of hard to stop it and kill it with the same thing.
Yeah. Difference is, like...
Kind of like a Gliscor.
Yeah, Gliscor is pretty much the only thing that can take a hit and kill it.
Difference is with Terrakion...
Excadrill all over again.
Well, no, Excadrill was a bit different.
Excadrill wouldn't want to take a close combat from it, though.
Oh, no. Like,
Excadrill
don't get me wrong,
could
there.
It, though, and kill it, so...
Yeah, it could kill with Earthquake after...
Only in the sand, though.
Well, one ever ran it outside of sand.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, Terrakion can be run any weather. Yeah.
It's like...
That's true, but it has a tendency of showing up more on sand teams or on
weather. Because in a sand team, you get a special defensive boost with it.
Yeah.
Which might just save you a hit against a weak special attacker, but...
Like a scald from a Polyglot or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, no. It's stupid. Polytope had the rainbow.
Yeah.
No, Gyarados. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I was going to say, Gyarados is physical attack. What are you talking about, Bane?
Gyarados shits all over it, man.
Yeah.
Kind of slow, bro. I don't know, man. Jesus.
Anyways, yeah. No, I think the problem with Ivysaur right now is there's nothing that's really like Gliscor that can kind of...
I mean, without a sub, Dodrio and Rapidash kind of just control it. But if it's got a sub up, if it goes for a sub as you switch, and then it just leech seeds you the next turn, gets a bit of recovery when you kill its sub, and then
it
switches
just switch out. Yeah, that's basically what Ivysaurs do, right? They switch in on like a resisted hit, they sub on the switch, then they like do something, they either attack you or they leech seed you or something. Get some recovery and switch out. And after, you know, if you count hazards into that as well, after a few turns, your sweepers who are trying to take out Ivysaur, they're not in very good shape anymore.
Exactly.
And, you know, eventually they either die or Ivysaur even just takes them out, you know? So you really have to play smartly when you're against that.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's enough about Ivysaur and PU, though.
Yeah.
I think slowly off topic.
So, yeah, we've covered all the tier changes, so let's move on to the Therian forms from Black and White 2 upgrades. We've touched on them a bit.
Well, all we can really say is Regenerator Tornadus T, Monster Speedster. Well, I say Monster Speedster. Scarfers outspeed it. If you don't run it Scarf. If you run it Scarf, nothing outspeeds it, but Scarfers outspeed it. It's a little bit frail, but it does have, you know, if you run Specs, you can get a Specs boosted Hurricane off on something, and that, you know, it's kind of powerful. I don't think it breaks the 400 mark on speed, though, without Scarf.
Personally, I don't think it needs the Scarf, because it's fast enough already.
But Thunderous T with a Scarf outspeeds it.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I wouldn't Scarf it, just because...
I think Life Orb is probably the best option for it.
Life Orb or Specs or something, but yeah. I wouldn't go Scarf, just because it lacks a lot of power with the Scarf.
Personally, I like Specs. It's what I've been running lately, and it just tears through stuff.
Yeah, I run it in Ubers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then there's the obvious Regenerator is a great build ability on it.
Yeah.
And it gets a U-turn.
Yeah. So.
I'm thinking of all switch. Well, no, hey. I want another switching move. In Gen 6, I want another switching move.
A fire type switching move.
Something cool and out of the blue, like,
Type switching move.
The only time I'd agree with that is if they had, like, if they agreed with my poison.
Your fire poison.
I tweeted Junichi Masuda again and asked him, like, can you do that? And he didn't reply to me because, as you all know, Junichi Masuda replies to everyone, right? Even the English speakers, but only if they draw him shitty fan art or compliment him.
Yeah.
If it's actual question regarding the game. Funny, he made that Twitter in order to talk with people about the game, but when someone actually talks to him about the game, he just sort of ignores them. So
yeah, but Satoshi Tajiri ignores everybody, so...
Yeah, he's just a prick, though. He's an Asperger's or something. But anyway, if they agreed with the... Because I had this idea where I wanted to make it so that poison was super effective against water. Because first of all, it would make sense logically, because, like, you know, if poison...
Somebody's poisoned the water hole!
Yeah, you know.
Guys, I just want to say right now, in the Pokefight Club chat, St. Raven just said, honk.
What the fuck?
I think that's a Homestuck reference.
That is a Homestuck reference, but it's kind of convenient because we were talking about you honking your horn earlier.
Yep.
It's because there's this character in Homestuck named Gamzee, and basically Gamzee, he's modeled after a Juggalo. He's like an alien, right?
And he's cool.
And basically the alien is in some weird religion where, like, they worship clowns and stuff, and basically he's just, like, they're making fun of Juggalos, right? And eventually, Gamzee goes completely. He starts, like, drinking Faygo, which is sort of like weed. It's like Faygo is really cheap, pop juice, like pop, you know. So like Orange Crush or whatever you want to call it, and it has this weird effect on him since he's an alien that makes him like really stoned. Okay, and as soon as he just stops drinking Faygo, he goes insane and becomes a freaking serial killer. So he goes around like chasing people and like murdering them, and in the comic, right before he murders someone, you hear, like, honk, honk, and then you see Gamzee coming with, like, a freaking butcher knife or something. Anyway, so that's probably what's going to
happen. Yeah, because he's called Cole Gamzee on Skype now.
Yeah, how great is that? Anyway.
So let's talk a bit about Landorus.
I just want to finish my thing about the water shit. Poison is a shitty attacking move. It used to be super effective against Bug in Gen 1, but they changed that. And frankly, I don't want to be super effective against Bug again, because Bug already has enough weaknesses and you don't need to pick on Bug.
So does Grass.
Water has very little weaknesses. It only has Grass and Electric. So, if you could add a third one in there, some of the bulky-ass water types would be a lot easier to deal with. and etc. Have a much funner time, in my opinion. Not to mention, if you had that and you also had a poison type switching move or something, I'm not really sure what it would be, but you know, you could sort of disrupt Volt Switch, not Volt Switch, Volt Turn,
yeah,
etc. Anyway, so one last thought about Tornadus before we move on to Landorus. I think that stat-wise, he's more of a UU poke, but the fact that he's Regenerator and that he fills such a good niche in
plus you can Volt Turn with Thunderous.
Yeah. Yeah, since he fits so well with Thunderous and Rain, or just, you know, in Rain by himself, I think that's the reason he's going to stay OU. But stat-wise, he's really not that impressive, and he'd easily go down to UU.
Yeah. Thunderous... man, that special attack that he has Landorus is just monstrous.
Yeah, Thunderous, like I said earlier, Thunderous with a Scarf hits over 4. I think it's like 438 special attack and like 452 speed.
What can survive that? Like,
I can just double check this right now. Let me just open up my...
I can tell you right now that on a max special defense, Blissey, if I remember well from my battle with Tyler, it does like something like 45% of Focus Blast, and that's max special defense Blissey, and not many people run that.
Okay, let's think, how many things in the metagame can survive more than 2 hits?
Well, not much, unless it's like from it resisted, you know? And even then, it's you have to be lucky, right?
Yeah.
You can't...
it's ridiculous. It's got...
Yeah.
There is not a single argument anyone can make to me that says that this thing won't go Ubers. Like, that special attack is unreal.
Yeah, Bane, accept that challenge I just sent you so I can look at this.
Okay. Oh, you want to go against my Blissey?
Alright, send your...
Okay, I'll lead with my Blissey, and you lead with your Thunderous.
So this is Scarf Thunderous. Yeah, so 450 speed, 427 special attack.
Hit me with a Focus Blast. This is max special defense Blissey. I just want to see how much it does.
Okay.
I think he does a respectable chunk, like around 30% or something.
Yeah.
Wow, there's a bit of lag here.
Yeah.
Look at this lag.
Yeah, stupid.
Yeah. Okay, there we go.
Oh, I pulled a crit.
I pulled a crit. Thanks, asshole.
I'll go for it again. I'll see what it does without crit. I'm probably going to miss now, though. 29%.
Yeah, around 30%. That's what I thought.
And that's with a Scarf.
Yeah.
And that's Scarfed, and that's against a fully specially defensive Blissey. And, you know, that's still 405 special defense and like 714 HP, so, you know.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's not even a stat Focus Blast.
And, like, how many people are going to run a fully special defensive Blissey? Like, most people will throw the EVs into defense so that she doesn't get wrecked by, like, Scissor or anything.
Well, in
Thank you, Tom.
Don't abuse your power.
Bane told me I could.
What, if someone challenges you without you? Just go idle, dick.
Who did you kick?
Troll.
Yeah, okay, well, he kicked someone named Troll. You're really going to complain about that, Tom?
Well, he kicked someone named Troll for challenging him, not for being a troll.
No.
Sorry.
Well, I think you should, like, sort of... If the guy just challenges you once, then... You know, just idle the next time, but if he, like, tries to spam challenge you, then kick him.
Okay,
anyways, Landorus. You know, I really want to like this guy just because he doesn't get any love, but...
UU, going to UU. I don't even care what anybody says, that's going to UU.
Yeah, I mean, Chandler is UU, Darmanitan is UU, they're both, like, really strong...
Flygon's UU.
Yeah. Well, Flygon you can't really compare Flygon because it's not like
Monster
he has a
cross. It's UU.
I'm talking about people with like 140 and above offensive stats. Okay, that's basically what he is, right?
Mm. Yeah, yeah, he's Chandelure on mana time range.
And he doesn't really have a move pool either. I mean, he's got Earthquake and stuff. But,
Earthquake,
yeah.
Stone Edge, Rock Polish.
Yeah.
Rock Polish, or you can learn the Scarf.
So.
Thing about Scarf with that thing is that he outspeeds most of the common Scarfers, with the exception of like Flygon. But even then, Flygon, you can sort of switch into it, get an Intimidate off, and then just whack whatever comes in next.
See, I feel that Landorus T is better used as like a bulky poke. Like, I use a sub-bulk upset, and Intimidate really helps out with that.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I can see that working with a bulk upset, but just as like a bulky, like, defensive utility poke, I don't think it would work, just because there's Gliscor that already fills that role.
I mean...
Oh yeah, definitely not defensive, yeah.
In OU, you send in Landorus T, someone's going to send in, like, a defensive... Or, like, even especially especially defensive Politoed wouldn't be able to take the, like, wouldn't be able to take an Earthquake without, like, even with the Scarf, probably wouldn't be able to take an Earthquake, would it? Not two, anyway.
Mm-hmm. No.
But you'd send in something that would... What's, like, a bulky water type? Like, in OU, you can't really compare it in... Gastrodon, but Gastrodon specially defensive. It's got kind of shit defense stats. What I'm trying to say is in, say...
I don't know. In, Blastoise, it doesn't matter. Just a bulky...
You would send it in, and then someone would go, right, well, my defensive Blastoise can take this, go in and scare it out with an Ice Beam. Or a Scald. Just, like, sub, and then it's kind of a waste. You need to have a way to kind of make sure you take other things out, because it's so frail, and it's kind of slow unless you Scarf it. So
I think that it would be welcome in UU. I'm not sure how much usage it would actually get.
Wouldn't be game breaking.
Yeah, it wouldn't be game breaking, but I mean, I think it would be nice to have, just because any offensive poke put in the tier kind of hinders the stall, which is always nice.
Yeah, it will kind of. It will either force Roserade to be used less or to be moved up, I suppose.
It's one of the reasons I don't know why Porygon Z went up. I think it would be fine in UU. I mean, sure,
Bane, I gotta stop you there. You're Canadian. Say Zed.
Porygon Zed went up from BL.
I say Z because I'm from fucking Quebec, and we don't really care.
Dude, it went up from BL2 to UU.
Yeah. Well, that's because I think they're
still
just...
in UU.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was the OU. Thank God. Jesus Christ. Okay, so it is the OU. Never mind.
They're just cleaning out the BL tiers right now. They'll be reset soon.
So what are we going to do? Staraptor, OU or UU? What do you think?
Oh, he'll never be UU.
I'm inclined to say UU because...
If it goes down to UU and Landorus T goes down to UU, imagine how offensive UU is going to be then with Scarfers.
Actually, yeah, I agree with this. I agree with that. I think that's a great idea. I think that, I mean, it's not like they don't have any checks. Gligar can take pretty much anything that Staraptor wants to do. What the fuck's it called, Jesus? The other thing, Suicune can take it relatively well. Bronzong can take it relatively well. Registeel can take... It's normal in flying attacks, not the close combat, but whatever. I think, you know, they're checked, but I mean, it's not like it's going to be doing nothing either.
And it'll really hinder stall.
Yeah. And I think I'm liking the Scarf idea on Landorus T, because I mean, you could just sort of like, they send in a Slowpro, and you U-turn, you hit it for a good chunk of damage, despite the fact that it's a defensive poke. And then you go into something that can check it, you know. I don't know, I think it would work very well.
I'd just like to point out that it likely could go UU because it is only getting 1.3 usage stat in
good.
OU.
I think that and Staraptor should go down to UU.
So, get rid of all this. That means we're going to be seeing more UU from Raven then.
Raven will immediately switch to UU the second that goes down.
Yeah,
I think if it goes down with Landorus T, it won't go straight back up. If it went down on its own, it would definitely go straight back up.
Yeah. Maybe not. I don't know.
I think that... Well, when did it go up, exactly?
When did it go up? I think
Staraptor has always been OU.
Yeah, Staraptor's all, I think it's been OU since the start, and it never really fell from BL, because it still kind of gets used in OU.
You mean, you're talking about 4th gen, right? It was OU and 4th gen.
Yeah,
it's been
OU,
OU
and 5th gen.
Since the very beginning of its time. So.
Okay, so, like, I don't understand why it's BL then. I mean, there's a bunch of defensive stuff that's sort of inflated UU.
I think it's Smogon's love for Roserade.
Fuck Roserade, man.
Because Roserade gets used, like, so much in UU for it to at least go BL.
It's still going to be used.
Roserade could even get used in OU, though. Like, that's the thing.
Yeah, Roserade is BL and PO.
Yeah, I mean, Roserade's not going to stop being used just because freaking a strong special attacker comes in. I mean, attacker, not special attacker. It's not just going to stop being used. I mean, Any physical attacker currently kills Roserade. It doesn't really matter.
And here's the thing: it's not like there isn't anything in UU that can stop or can't stop Staraptor, because there's Rhyperior there. There's a whole bunch of stuff that can take hits from it damage out. There's Gligar there. There's Gligar or Gligar or however the fuck you want to pronounce
Dusclops.
Dusclops. Yeah, there's so much stuff there that can take hits and. Deal
Why
a respectable
is it, what
chunk.
The fuck? Why is it BL? I don't. I mean, I used to think like, oh yeah, it's really strong. That's why it's BL. But I mean,
it's BL because, like Cliff said, Smogon loves stuff like Roserade and doesn't want to take any power away from it at all.
In my opinion, Roserade should be BL and Staraptor should be UU because Roserade gets used like 24%. I think last usage stats it was like 24% of the time.
Well, here, let me
people
pull
had Roserade on their team. It was something ridiculously high.
Hmm.
You know, that might have been in the 1337 rating thing.
Yeah.
But it gets used so much. I always see Roserade.
I think that for the best of the tier, that change would have to be made. Bringing Rhyperior, not Rhyperior, bringing goddammit, I'm really on the ball tonight.
Staraptor and Landorus.
Yes, Staraptor and Landorus T.
Roserade gets 1.8 usage stats in OU, and in UU, Roserade gets... I gotta scroll down a bit.
It's only stupidly high, isn't it?
It's definitely first.
Fuck. Let me get my glasses. Ah, shit.
Little old Soulfate can't see without his glasses anymore.
Yeah, Roserade gets 20.
Boy, I used to play Pokemon without glasses.
Did you say 20?
23.6% usage in UU. It easily could go OU and or BL.
The thing is, it wouldn't go OU because it would take the OU usage stats for it to go OU. So it would go BL if it were to be moved up.
Yeah, it definitely could go BL, and that would take away from the stall quite a bit.
I have no problem with Roserade being there, though. I mean,
yeah.
It gets destroyed by any freaking...
Darmanitan and Flygon both destroy
really...
it.
Any physical attacker destroys it. It doesn't matter. It's just it's got garbage physical defense.
Yeah, it's really just send Staraptor down to UU, and that'll solve a lot of the problems that are in UU right now with
it'll
stall.
Cut... Stall will be used less, because offense will look so much more appealing.
Yeah. That's one of the reasons why I stopped playing UU this gen, because, like, I'm fine with stall, but UU this gen is just ridiculously stally.
Again, I'm going to say check out POUU. It's so much more balanced.
Yeah, I'm inclined to agree with Tyki there. I mean, as much as I hate POUU, POUU is a lot better than Smogon UU.
There's only a few things that I really have to disagree with POUU. Actually, no, there's one big thing that I disagree with, and I think we spoke about it. Us lot spoke about it the other day, and it's Virizion.
Yeah.
I absolutely cannot agree. Any way you use Virizion is good.
Oh, I mean, if Staraptor drops down.
If Staraptor drops down, but the thing is, Staraptor's in OU.
It's Smogon. Keep that in mind.
It's BL and PO. I just don't see how Virizion has managed to... It's like BL2, isn't it, Virizion?
Yeah, I think so.
In, PO...
let's see.
I think it's like BL2, or at least bottom of UU usage stats on PO, and I just don't understand it. Like, I don't understand how a Scavalier got to NU. It's kind of ridiculous. It just confuses. It actually confuses me and makes me a tiny little bit angry, because I've used Virizion so much to sweep, and it's so easy to sweep with, and like if you don't have like a check for it, something to stop the grass fighting type, which in OU is actually amazing coverage.
Breloom. Yeah, Breloom's a huge threat. Isn't Technoloom out?
Technoloom is
Yes,
out.
It is, and it is beautiful, dude.
Bullet Seed. Source
we
Dance.
We will get into that in a
punch.
Bit.
Does it get any multi-hit fighting attacks? No, actually, all the multi-hit fighting attacks are garbage. Never mind.
That's only Arm Thrust.
Yeah, and it's
dude, Bullet Seed, Mach Punch, Source Dance, Spore.
Why would you why would you run that? You have Mach Punch, Jesus. What's wrong with me?
What were you about to say?
We're getting the one like super good part about Technoloom. Mach Punch.
Yeah.
Okay, so we got three black and white 2 poke releases left to talk about. Keldeo and the 2 Kyurem forms. Which one do you guys want to start with?
Let's start with Keldeo.
Yeah.
Let's start Brock with Keldeo, since he's been using it a ludicrous amount because he was sick. Disgusting obsession with
Alright, yeah, I'm fine talking about it. Personally, I've been using a Swords Dancing Keldeo set, which I do not recommend if you are not using it in rain. Because otherwise that Aqua Jet will do shit, and that Aqua Jet is pretty much a necessity to kill off a lot of things.
Guys, Calm Mind Terrakion's legit, use it.
Yeah, totally. But yeah, this Keldeo, it can run a Swords Dancing set, but I only recommend running it in the rain, otherwise it's trash. Scarf is probably your best bet. Not so much specs, because it does need the extra speed, and it is really frail. So definitely go Scarf over specs if you are going to run a specially attacking set.
Doesn't it have the same defensive stats as Terrakion, though?
I don't think it does. I think it's less. Let me double check.
I'm pretty sure it is the same.
Okay, guys, before we go on, Gym Leader Big Bang, that guy who wanted to be a mod, I said, all right, so you got to do this, and only PFC people are allowed. If you apply for it to be a director and join the PFC and blah, 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 did I say all of that? I said, I'm recording a podcast, but I'll look into it later. And he's like, okay, so can I become a mod? Like, did you not just listen to anything I just said? Christ.
Alright, so Keldeo has 90 defenses. Yeah, it's got the same.
And it has a better defensive typing.
Except Terrakion has 91 HP, and I think Keldeo has 89, which isn't a big difference.
Keldeo also has 91 HP.
Oh, no, it does. Yeah, I was looking at something
else.
Keldeo is
just a reverse Terrakion.
No, but I do find it, like, in comparison to Terrakion, I find it just doesn't take hits as well. I don't know what it is. Like, I don't know if it's just me, but I find it is really frail in comparison to Terrakion and Virizion. I might just
That's
be talking
well, about I mean, it's frail compared to Kybalion and Virizion.
Oh, well, yeah, definitely.
I mean, Terrakion isn't really bulky. Terrakion's like...
No.
See, if you look at
but,
it, actually...
But see, Terrakion... Terrakion gets the sand boost on its specially defensive.
I'm about to say, Terrakion is the physical attacker, Keldeo's the special attacker, Kobalion's the physical wall, Virizion's the special wall.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how it's supposed to work.
Yeah. I agree 100% with that. But yeah, Scarf Keldeo over specs. If you're going to run physical Keldeo, you have to run Swords Dance and you have to run it in the rain. Otherwise,
don't run physical Keldeo.
Yeah, don't run it. Or
I mean, run Aqua Jet for priority, but
yeah, like Aqua Jet.
If you know, if something goes,
you don't need the priority.
If you're running Scarf, you don't need it.
That's true.
Specs, I just don't find that viable on it. So
isn't there an extra Keldeo?
Hold a second. I'm sorry, but can you just switch onto a scissor, resist the bullet punch? Yeah.
Yeah. It can.
Yeah, it's like...
No, it's only 2 times.
Is it... Does fighting not resist it, then?
Fighting does not resist it.
What I was going to say, isn't there another Keldeo form?
Yeah, there is a second Keldeo form. Now, this this thing, it's really stupid.
It has
the moves. Yeah, it has
the resolute form.
Yes, it's called the resolute form. The only difference between it and the regular Keldeo is it's gonna have the move Secret Sword, and the sprite for it looks a slight bit different. And basically, it kind of spoils you possibly running any kind of like gimmicky set at all, which isn't that big a deal, but it shows that you are definitely a special attacking set.
Well, no, all it shows is that you've definitely got Secret Sword.
Yeah, but if you got the Secret Sword, like, really, you're going to be running mostly... You're probably going to run all special attacking set.
Run Secret Sword, though, so you can kill those Blissies.
Yeah, the only reason why anyone would run Keldeo is if they're going to have close combat. But Secret Sword, yes, it's a great move to have for killing off Blissies.
Ferrothorn as well. Don't
is it
that,
Secret Sword or Sacred Sword?
Sacred is the physical one.
Sacred is like, what's that move? Chip away, I think?
Yeah.
Where it ignores all stat changes.
Oh.
And all the guys...
Close combat just is better.
Some people choose to run it as a filler move on Terrakion, just as, like, to wall break, but...
My filler move on Terrakion's Earthquake.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. You're probably better off running something else.
Earthquake, X-Scissor are my fillers.
X-Scissor really isn't a filler in my opinion, but...
I class it as a filler because, you know, what does X-Scissor hit for more damage than Stone Edge does?
Slowbro, doesn't it?
Yeah, but how many Slowbros do you really see? And would you want to keep Terrakion in on a Slowbro?
Mm-hmm. I mean, if you're predicting it.
If you're predicting it, yeah.
But then again, you might fuck up the prediction. So.
All anyway, right.
But yeah, that's Keldeo. And now Reshiram White and... Not Reshiram White. Kyurem White and Kyurem Black.
Kyurem Black.
All right. Okay. I'll let you guys talk about this because I don't...
Yep, this is for me and me.
Okay, you can do Kyurem Black and I'll do Kyurem White. Good? Because you use Kyurem Black a lot more than I do. So. Kyurem White, just amazing in every way. I mean, there's not really much else there is to say there. It's just really good in every single way possible. GG.
Kyurem White is... I think the only really viable thing I can see with Kyurem White is Specs. Not Specs, Scarf.
Scarf or Specs, it doesn't even matter. It hits so stupidly hard.
And then Kyurem Black, I think you got a tiny little bit more freedom with it. Apart from the having a, like a lack of a good physical ice move.
The only time you'd be able to run a good physical ice move is if you run a power of the combos.
Yeah, if you run my set, I run kind of like a tricky set, like a sub power herb thing, because people tend to think, all right, like I'm either going to go for a fusion bolt or outrage. They can if they've got a Gliscor, they go into their Gliscor. You did this, Bane. I did this to you.
Yes.
You went into Gliscor and I subbed, and they just automatically assumed that I couldn't have the power herb.
Yeah, I was like, okay, he's home class, that's cool. And then, wha-bam.
So Ben goes, all right, I'm going to go for like Stealth Rocks or something, I don't know.
But I was like, he's probably going to go for his ice shit now that he's in back of a sub. So I got one turn to set up rocks or whatever, or Earthquake, or I don't even know what I was doing. I think it was an Earthquake to break your sub or something like that. But I went for that, and I was like, okay, that's cool, and then I'll protect next turn and then avoid his ice shit. And then, like, boom, freaking power.
Which I think is a good thing to catch people off, because people like to go into Giratina on it. I don't know why.
But yeah, I don't know why people do that.
People seem to like to go into Giratina. They think, oh, I'm going to go into Giratina. I mean...
But I don't understand that, because...
Outrage would kill you anyway.
Outrage would kill you, yeah. Why are you doing that?
Whatever.
And that is a very good leeway talking about Gliscor for our next section.
Dreamworld releases. That's our next section. Cool.
Are we going Dreamworld releases or
Dreamworld releases is next?
Isn't it MoveTube? MoveTube and not Dreamworld there.
It's Dream World move tutor, and like you put them together.
It's a black white move tutor, not Dream World move tutor.
Yeah.
Whatever.
So, anyways, we're gonna talk about the Dream World releases. I think I messaged you guys all the
you did.
Posts. Yeah.
You messaged us the fifth gen changes, and that was it.
Yeah. Oh, that's all it had. Shit. Okay. Here, I think I've.
Okay, I really want to talk about one in particular, and that is Moxycross.
Yeah.
Moxycross is ridiculous.
It's very good, I agree. I think the only problem it has is that it can get burned by Sableye, but that's what it is.
Okay, so there's the Hidden Hollow links.
I actually want to mention Superpower on Scolipede.
Oh my god, yeah. But it already had Earthquake, so it's not really that much of an improvement. But
and also, Superpower on Haxorus, I mean, come on.
Dude, you think Haxorus is bad? Haxorus got it, Fracture also got it. And so did Zweilous and stuff like that, so thank
sucker,
god.
Sucker Punch Pawniard.
Well, that was already kind of hard.
That thing. Fucking.
Oh, right, yeah. It's funny, a little mini story anecdote thing before we get too in-depth in the next topic. Tom was playing me, and I was like, alright, but I don't have any good NU teams. I only have the shitty PU teams that I haven't even tried out, and it's all stupid, and I played it when I was like drunk or something. So he sends out this like mega try-hard NU team, like really, really try-hard, like Golurk.
Amoongus, Basculin, Regirock.
Yeah, freaking superpower basketball and all that stuff, right? Just like really, really coring it out to the max. And the funny thing, to give you just an idea of how bad my team was, I had a scarfed Ghastly on it. Okay, yeah, okay. Not only that, I had a scarfed Ghastly with sub pain split.
What?
I was like, I don't know. I guess I was really fucking drunk or something, or maybe under some other substance, but I think I was like, alright, Scarf, we're gonna do this. And I was like, no, wait, I gotta be like that guy I faced that one time with the Haunter and use a super fast sub-curse guy with Pain Split. And then, like, I only replaced half the movesets, and I never really paid attention to it. So yeah, I had that. I had, like, a Pineco, I think a Specs Exploud, and, like, I don't know, some other bullshit. And one of my pokes was, like, a Ponyard. Oh, yeah, I also had a Cursed Marsh Stomp. So I had Cursed Marsh Stomp, Ponyard, that, and some other things. But anyway, I ended up sweeping, like, half of his team with Cursed Ponyard.
Swords Dance, Sucker Punch, Ponyard, because my team was Sucker Punch weak.
Sucker Punched half his team away, and then killed the rest of it with Cursed Marsh Stomp. It was funny.
Because it had fucking rest. I thought I'd killed it with my fucking...
I knew you'd think that. Dude, you gotta remember, I'm very fond of running rest and not sleep talk. Because, like, I figure that... I do that with my Cradley, too. I figure that after enough boosts, if you have enough, if your prey defense or special defense or whatever you're running, if it's curse or calm mind or whatever, if it's high enough, then if you get enough curses up, you can sort of survive any hit for, like, two turns. And you don't really need to worry about sleep talk. Anyway, so yeah, we were talking about new Dream World stuff. Speaking of which, Sleep Talk is one of the Sleep Talk is one of the move tutor moves. So
yeah, that's move tutor.
One that I wanna mention really quickly is Stored Power on Sigalith.
It's already
had Stored Power.
It's got it here mentioned as a new egg move. This is what I was pointing out.
No, it's mentioning that it gets the Dream World ability with.
No, it got Heat Wave as well. Which is actually kind of cool.
Heat Wave is cool, but I suppose you could run it, but...
Well, when it says egg move, though, it means that the egg move is legal with the Dream Up ability.
It doesn't mean it has a new egg move. Anyway,
I have a bit of a list here of all, of like, some key stuff that came out. Prankster Liepard, I know Bane's been using this a lot in PU. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's the set you've been running on that?
Sorry, repeat that? I totally phased out there for a second.
Oh. Prankster Lifehard.
Yeah, you can run a bunch of stuff on. You can run Nasty Plot. You can run a variety of things. I've grown very fond of being a total dickhead and running Substitute, Foul Play, Swagger, and Thunderwave.
Fucking so,
I love that thing, dude. It's so good. It's like Sableye, but for PU.
It's a water-absorbed Timple.
Yeah, that's, I don't know, that's interesting.
That's pretty cool for PU.
Yeah, you could, well, you'd use Palpitoad.
Aquajet, Bear Dick.
Seismitoad, yeah.
See, what I don't understand is that they gave it, this is another example of Troll Freak, right? They gave it Swift Swim, and then they gave it Aquajet, but it's already going to be faster than everything else in the rain. So.
Whoa, hold on, you can catch Multiscale Dragonite in-game?
Yeah, you can. Cool, huh?
Okay, right, so, I'm
gonna
go.
Bye, Tom, see you in never.
I'm gonna go now, guys, I'll talk to you. I'm definitely gonna do some, like, in-game EV training if I have to, just to have Multiscale Dragonite in-game. I don't even care.
And then there's also Regenerator Duo.
Yeah. Don't worry, Tom, I'll catch a Multiscale Dragonite just for you in my Black and White 2 Let's Play.
Oh, dude, Breloom with Technician is catchable in-game as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we also have Regenimoongus that I know everybody has been whoring, and I'm guilty of it myself.
And Regen Amamola.
Sheer Force Bagon. Have you guys noticed that?
Yeah, Sheer Force Bagon, that's Moxie.
That's Moxie Men's.
Sheer Force Hariyama.
I'm not sure how I'm feeling about that. On one hand, it's good, but on the other hand, Stone Edge can benefit from it, and Close Combat...
I feel like Guts outclasses it.
Yeah, me too. I mean, that is if you're using a Hariyami, which hardly anyone ever does.
And then Motor Drive, Emolga.
It's like Hayden. Is it Aryu or Enyu? I think it's Enyu, right?
Aryama? I'm pretty sure it's Aryu.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I know, Sock is a lot better. Okay, first of all, Sock is going Aryu, now that it got all its punches and its coverage is all sorted out.
Yep.
So, just calling that now. If I'm wrong, then
it's
I'm right.
It's kind of weird, these punches. Wrong. I mean, seriously.
Oh, shit, I thought you said it got the punches for a second. I was like, what?
No, I said it needs it.
Garbodor got Aftermath, which I guess is pretty cool.
Kling Klang got Wild Charge, which I am pretty excited about.
Yeah.
Actually,
do something real quick.
What I think is kind of cool is Poison Touch Muk.
I'd like to agree with you. I really do. But I don't, because Sticky Holds is a lot better. And Poison Touch is garbage.
And Poison Jab already has 30% chance to poison.
Yeah, you don't need to poison.
That's true.
I mean, I'd run it. No, you know what I'd do? I'd run it in the game and then just, like, poison all the guy's Pokemon with Poison Jab and then insist that it's Sticky Hold and he's just really unlucky.
Yeah.
That's what I'd do.
I don't know. I think it's really cool.
I'm looking into this now. Grimer with Violite as a physical wall. But it has Sticky Hold, so it can't get knocked off.
Ooh. Oh, that actually sounds pretty good.
Let me just open up Team Builder.
What about a special wall, though? It doesn't have that as special defense.
No, it's not like Muk. I think it's equal. They both have 50, which is... 50 is like... Yeah. But on the other hand, it has 80 base HP, which is a lot better than most of Violite users. So I think it would be... good. Not as good as coughing, physically. But, it also has a better move pool. Or something. Anyway, just something else.
I also have to mention this because they told me to. Duran, Truant Duran is released, but it can't get entrainment with it, so the Troll Freak strikes again.
Yep. Woo! Troll Freak.
Yay.
And then Golett with no Gardier.
Trubbish also got Aftermath, like I said, so I guess it could be cool as like sort of a suicide lead in PV. And it is also a much more viable suicide lead in Enyu, because that's basically how you use it, let's be honest. Just like stick Rock Blast and shit on it. Rock Blast, Gunk Shot, and like Toxic Spikes or whatever.
It spikes, Toxic Spikes, Gunk Shot, yeah. And Explosion, I think.
I see a lot of people run Rock Blast. Just because Rock there's Blast? Like, yeah, there's like Ninja Ask and shit. But,
true.
And like Charizard now. But, yeah, I suppose you could run. Wait. Let me. 1 second. Grimer has base 80 attack. That's actually pretty high.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm making a team around it right Grimer, now for PU.
I mean, if ever Muck got banned, I'm just going to do a quick calculation. This is what happens in the Hitmonchat. We keep discovering things.
I was using, when you banned Muck, I switched to using Grimer before. Don't you remember?
Yeah, I remember that. I don't think I ever got the battle to Grimer. But... Okay, so... 327 special defense and 364 HP after a Violite. That's defense or special defense. So I suppose you could run...
With Pain Split.
I won't run Pain Split, though. I'd run, like, Rest or something. It's got too much HP for Pain Split.
Well, you run Pain Split on Muck.
That's because, that's if you don't run it with Rest, though, and you're, like, at zero HP.
Guys, I don't know about you, but I'm pretty damn excited for Unnerve Axew.
Oh, shit.
That's almost as big as when Unnerve Tyranitar came out. That thing was huge.
Yeah, man. You can run it on, like, rain teams and sun teams. And
dude, I troll Unnerve Tyranitar, but when I used to play Challenge Cup, I once got Unnerve Tyranitar, and this guy had Resto Chesto. I didn't realize I had Unnerve Tyranitar. And he rested, and he didn't wake up, and I killed him.
That is amazing.
That is pretty good.
Just a quick question. Do any of you guys see any use for Sniper Beedrill in PU?
Okay, a lot of people were trolling about that, actually.
I use it.
Is it legit?
I use it. It's legit.
So you
I
can
use
run
it
a cross poison on it?
In PU, my word is God, so it's legit. Wait, it learns cross poison?
Yeah, it learns cross poison, I'm pretty sure.
No, I don't think so.
No.
If it learned cross poison, I'd be using cross poison. No. But,
no, it doesn't.
It does get drill run, though, thanks to the move tutor. So you can run it with drill run and, like...
X-Scissor doesn't have boosted crit.
I tend to use U-turn instead of X-Scissor, but... here, let me just see if there's any other crit stuff. Or it's just more trophy.
Yeah, but you don't have to, like, you don't have to abuse your ability completely, I mean
yes, they don't.
It's for coverage.
Oh, Electroweb, Caterpie, and Weedle. Don't forget about that.
So Electroweb, Caterpie, and Weedle means that Butterfree and Beedrill get Electroweb, then.
Did you know that knockoff is a move to remove in Black White 2? I don't know that.
Yeah. They obviously wanted to make PU really strong.
I heard my piece. Oh, dude, Jinichi Masuda, he must have done it.
he must be a fan of the BSC.
After my first tweet, which is like right before Black and White 2 release, he was like, we gotta halt the production, guys. Gotta put a knockoff. And then they just reviewed everything and
just put knockoff on everything, strictly for PU.
Exactly.
Man, I've held this since we started PU, but knockoff is by far the strongest move.
Yeah, cool. I'd agree.
Mm-hmm.
Like Matang in our tournament still, because we're not gonna ban it because we're keeping with the last tier change. But if you knock off when Matang's in, like I literally will let my Sandshrew die as long as I can knock off a Matang.
Well, that's what's great about this. I call them little fuckers, okay? And they God damn it, Tech.
What did you do?
I think we forgot to talk about a new Pokemon.
That's great, but let me talk about this few bullshit first, okay? I think that they fall in sort of like an archetype of PU Pokemon. Like, you know, there's tanks and there's walls and there's wall breakers and there's sweepers, you know, stuff like that. I think this would be a new archetype for PU that's just called Little Fucker. And it should consist of NFEs with just irritating movesets. And that would be basically like Tentacool, Kabuto, Sandshrew, Duskull, just because, like, Duskull. But, you know, just little fuckers who, like, without a violet, they would be nothing, but because they have it, they just dominate everyone.
Yeah.
What was that new Pokemon you were talking about, Tyki?
I might be wrong.
Probably are.
I probably am wrong. But I'm pretty sure Meloetta is getting released soon.
I'm pretty sure Meloetta
is released.
Is released, but it got released after the last tier change.
Yeah. So it hasn't really been placed. I think it's just OU. It's like flat out OU.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's OU.
I'm... No?
Go on, Smogon.
I think it's OU. I'm not sure, though. But the point is... The point is it's a pretty good Pokemon, but it's not that amazing. Actually, it is really amazing. What am I talking about? Meloetta, I remember, I was always marveling about this. It's got really cool stat distribution.
Fighting form is amazing.
Yeah, Meloetta is released, it's OU.
The fighting form is amazing, but it's just, it's annoying because you have to sacrifice a move slot.
For what?
Activate it. Well, for Meloetta.
Plus, you have to waste a turn with it in.
Because
it was awesome if it sleeves. Because it does get Serene Grays.
Yeah, and the cool thing about that is that I don't think that his sleeping move thing is affected by Sleep Claws. So it's got a 20% chance on every hit because of Serene Grays to put someone to sleep. And it's unaffected by Sleep Claws.
I'm pretty sure on PO... I'm pretty sure on PO it'll be scripted in to be affected by Sleep Claws, but... On Smogon, it technically can't be affected by Sleep Claws unless they're going to ban that move completely.
Which would completely, like, make Meloetta NU.
Yeah, because...
Which move is that, though?
Okay, let's not be harsh here. Keep in mind that even regular Meloetta has 128 special attack and special defense at 90 speed, so it's still a good Pokemon. Mm-hmm.
What is the song? What is the... Is it Relic song?
Yeah, Relic song.
Okay, yeah.
10% chance. 10% chance to put an opponent to sleep.
20% with the
10%. Oh yeah, 10%. 20% with Serene Grace. Oh yeah.
But fighting form gets 128 speed and 128 attack, so that's also really good.
Do you know what I love about when they bring new moves in? When they create new moves, Smiggle's move pool gets bigger.
Oh my god.
Yeah, because Relic Song Smiggle's definitely gonna work.
I was thinking more,
Fuck Spore, we got Relic.
I was thinking more, what's it called? Brock, I rebooted it, that's why.
Okay. Apparently, fighting Meloetta, though, has the highest, highest speed in base stat total of all fighting type Pokemon.
What, with 90?
No, fighting type Meloetta.
Oh, sorry, my bad.
Highest speed of all... Yeah, that makes sense.
And also has the highest base stat total of all fighting type Pokemon.
That also makes sense. It's 600, and there's no pseudo-legendaries or fighting type or legendaries. Like, I mean, like, actual legendaries, not like trios.
Yeah.
Technically, they are legendaries, though.
So
yeah,
they're just not like... There's two different kinds of legendaries. They're trios.
Five AD base stat totals, so I don't really consider them legendaries, especially since pseudo legendaries are on and slacking.
128 base speed. That is very high base speed.
Yeah, I think
very, very good base speed.
You just need like one turn to activate it, that's the only problem. But
and you're fucked if they switch into a ghost type.
Thing is, on that one turn, I mean, what do you think?
I mean, most of them run Shadow Claw, and what's its base attack?
It can't change if so it'll be stuck with its like 90 base attack.
What I can see it doing is switching in onto some sort of like
actually 77 base attack.
Yeah, it's stuck with that and it can't change form. And if it goes for it on the first turn and they switch, they've just been able to switch in their ghost type for free.
Yeah, I really don't like their mechanic there. I think it should just be... It would be a lot more useful, but of course Game Freak doesn't give a fuck about
it. It would be broken if it started out like that.
I don't think it would be broken.
I think well, not yet. I mean, that's like saying the new Thunderous form is broken just because it starts differently to how Tornado the...
No, I'm saying it's the setup, like...
Yeah, I think it would be pretty broken because it does have 100 base HP and 90 base...
What's its defense?
90.
90 and 100 defense, base 77 HP.
Special defense.
So a base, like, a Mach Punch won't kill it. A Vacuum Wave won't kill it.
What about from Swords Dance in Technoloom? Swords Dance on the Switch.
Okay, well, yeah, but that's
one. Very situational.
Why did you switch in the middle of it on a Prelude in the first place?
I know, but that's why it's very situational.
You know, funny thing about that is that if you have, like, I don't know, Relic Song, Psychic, then, like, two physical attacks or something, you can just switch in as regular Meloetta. Even non-invested, your base special attack is still going to be very high.
128 as the Psychic form.
You could hit that that Breloom with a Psychic, kill it, and then, you know, then... Whatever, I don't know.
But until it switches form, the breeding wouldn't come in on it, would it?
No. But look,
then it can't Swords Dance on the Switch.
Yeah, exactly.
Like all I right. said, it was kind of situational.
Very situational. Anyway.
Yeah, you'd have to be facing AJ to have it happen.
Very good. That's the verdict. Very good. Potentially broken if it didn't have the mechanic that it does have, but it does have that mechanic, so it's like... Think of it this way, at least it's not another Zen mode Darmanitan, okay?
Dude, we forgot something that wasn't actually on that list there and should have been on that list. Mew went up to OU.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
It did.
I
Mew
am did very excited for that.
Yeah, it's quite good.
In UU was too good, in my opinion.
It's good for it stops. It stops stall. Back to the
Mew,
point.
If Arceus is the god of Pokemon, Mew is like Adam and Eve. Okay, it's just fine.
Yeah. It just has bad type. That's it.
It doesn't even matter. You can just boost with it. You don't even need to run defensively.
Yeah, it learns almost every move in the game.
It learns every single TM in the game.
Could you imagine if Mew got Sketch as a move to your move?
Oh my god.
Could you imagine how OP Mew would be?
Ubers.
Base 100 stats in every move in the
game. Base 100 stats with Spore?
Tyki, it wouldn't be Ubers, it would be...
Shell Smash Mew. GG.
Shell Smash Mew, man.
Tyki,
Shell Smash, like Psychic or Psyshock or some shit.
Shell Smash, Smell Smash. Shell Smash.
But try to do that 5 times fast.
Shell Smash.
Shell Smash.
Shell Smash, Spore.
Psy Shock, which is the one that hits your special attack to their defense, and Aura Sphere.
Dude, Psy Strike. What are you talking about?
Alright, sorry, Psy Strike. Shit, no,
it's not Mewtwo, it doesn't get Psy Strike.
It's actually
If it had Sketch.
You're right.
Sketch, it would get anything.
Anyways, so yeah, let's briefly touch on just some of the other pokes that were released with Black and White 2 before we move on. Well, we won't go into too much detail about these ones because they've already been talked to death over, but there's Toxic Boost Zangoose, Sheer Force Kingler, Reckless Bianfu, Technoloom.
Some of those were already released, just so far.
Yeah, Imposter Ditto, Moxie Cross, and Moxie Pinsir.
I love Moxie Pinsir. I like that. One thing that pisses me off about Pinsir is that it doesn't have like some sort of boosted move or something. It would be cool if it did.
What pisses me off about Pinsir is just shit Heracross without Fight and Stab. Because the first time I used it 4th gen, right, in NU, it looks... Fuck you. I played 4th gen a lot, okay? Like, I didn't like Aiden, and I've never...
That makes one of us. I didn't even know what the fuck EV training was in 4th gen.
But it looks so good, but it's kind of a letdown, just because Bug isn't really good coverage, and you only get stabbing Bug, so... Especially in NU, Bug isn't really good coverage. Fighting's quite good coverage in NU.
I think Pinsir's one of those Pokemon that they should pull like a Magmortar on. So like you know what they did in 4th Gen where they just took a bunch of
give it an extra evolution.
They took a bunch of decent Pokemon and they just made them better.
Yeah, think, Magneton, Magmar, Electabuzz, Magneton,
Sneasel, Electabuzz,
Gligar.
Gligar, yeah. Honchkrow, stuff like that, you know? And I think if I was to do anything, I'd make it like... I want to say like an armored beetle that's like Steel Bug or something. I don't want to be making
Fighting Bug. That's a Scavalier.
Okay. Steel Bug, I don't want to say because we have enough Steel Bugs. Fighting Bug, I don't want to say because we already have
Heracross.
That's stupid to do that. But I think Ground Bug would be cool.
Ninkata and Wormadam.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, there's no real...
But having a strong...
Yeah.
There isn't
a ground bug. Ninkata's steel bug, isn't he?
No, yeah, it's ground bug. And
it is Wormadon.
Wormadon ground.
Yeah, Wormadon ground. Speaking of Wormadon, it's still broken on PO. It's gonna piss me off.
Yeah, I sent a bug report on it, and they confirmed it, so they're gonna fix it in the next patch.
Okay, good. That pissed me off. The only way I could, I think the only way I could use one is by importing one of my old teams with Wormadon. And then, like, you had it. It's pretty cool.
It's ridiculous. So it's you like, just go back and build a team on the old team builder and just import it.
Yeah, that's pretty much all you have to do.
But, also, go ahead.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say Ground Bug or Rock Bug, because Rock Bug is always cool.
Wormadam and Rock.
Okay, shut up. But I'd like to say Rock Bug, but I think Armaldos pretty much got that covered, and I think they'd be kind of obsolete, to be honest.
Rock dual types are actually really good, have you noticed this?
Yeah, they're very offensively, at least.
Like, Terrakion.
Yeah, Terrakion. All kinds of bug types.
In the tiers that they're in, they're actually really good. Karakosta.
Rhyperior.
You know.
He's a boss.
Corsola.
Yeah. Yeah.
Another new thing that Black and Two, Black, wait.
Yes.
Black Shadow and Tag, two Shadow Tag, Chandler.
Okay, that's not released, thank God. But
Jesus. I hope not.
Stat boosting berries.
Yeah, a few of them were released, not all of them, so.
Yeah, just a few of them. Which one do you have released? Which ones were released?
I think they're on that Hollow. The Hollow.
Yeah, but it's not. It's not like
one.
It's not like very accurate. It just sort of lists everything that got released that's in there.
I sort of know them, so it shouldn't be a problem. One second.
I don't know if you guys have a thread that has all of them listed.
What is
there.
The berry dex on?
Yeah, berry dex, man.
Yeah.
It's like any berries here? Nope. Berries? Nope. Berries? Nope.
So, how you guys doing?
Pretty good berries. berries. Where the fuck are the berries? How far down are they? Jesus Christ.
So...
Berries, come on,
guys,
berries.
I would just like to say...
What
are we actually on at the moment? We're talking about...
New Pokemon that came out, and...
Are we kind of talking about Dreamworld and Mewtwo stuff all at the same time?
Well, this is fine. They sort of go hand in hand, right?
Because one thing that I did want to mention, Heatmore is PU, right?
Yeah.
Because it got Giga Drain. And Heatwave.
Wait, Heatmore got Giga Drain?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh. I mean, I guess it's like an anteater, and it can, like, drain with its tongue. I don't fucking know. By the way, no berries in Hidden Hollows. Just fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, it got Giga Drain, which I thought was kind of cool. And it's good coverage in PU as well.
Oh, yeah. I'm not sure if it was already there, but every single EV... evolution with a hidden ability has been released.
Weren't they all already released anyway?
Yeah, I think so.
It was just Eevee that wasn't.
Leafeon wasn't released. And Leafeon got Chlorophyll, and now it's released. So, don't quote me on that. I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure
Leafeon was definitely released.
It was?
Yeah. Maybe it's just that it wasn't released, but you can catch Eevee in-game now. I think Eevee got released on Dreamworld. Eevee might have been one of the, like... I think it's got released ages ago, because Hydration Vaporeon's been around for ages.
Yeah, no, you're right. Scratch that. But
we had that little game you had to play, like...
Yeah, just like a little stupid Dream World game. I did some of the Dream World, then I discovered like Pokégen, and I was like, what the fuck am I doing this for?
Yeah, I saw someone attempt to do, like, they were tempted to, like, get everything legit, and, like, EV train it legit, and they only did, like...
I mean, like, people who want to do it for fun, that's great. You know, if you want to, like, a homegrown, your own Pokemon team, it'll be, like, your team, and you use
I mean, I did that in fourth gen.
Yeah, like, that's fine. I have no problem with that. I have no beef with it. You're going to have a bit of trouble IV training. You might have to, like, RNG cheat a bit, but that's not legit, so, you know, don't do that. But if you're seriously going to do competitive battling, wanting to legit breed all of your shit yourself, that's just fucking stupid, okay?
Yeah, it takes fucking ages, man. No, Sav it all. That's what I'm going to say. Sav it all.
Yeah, but, it's not even a question of, like, it's not even a question of, you know, I worked hard on this team, and because if
sorry,
you have...
It's more of a question you've wasted 2 weeks of your life doing that per poke.
2 weeks if you're lucky, okay? If you make one team for
That's 2 weeks. That's 2 weeks per poke, I'm saying.
Yeah, legendaries are even worse. Oh, unless you have, like, master balls. But legendaries are just go meet the legendary.
To do it legit is ridiculous.
Some of legendaries, their stats and everything are predetermined as soon as you begin a game. So you literally have to start a new game and then just get to the legendary, check what it is.
I think
your game do that shit again and again and again.
I think it's Tornadus and Thunderous. They were preset to have stats and IVs and
Rayquaza as well.
The second you see it, the first time you see it, and then it could take you with Rayquaza. You see it, and then everything gets set, and you have to go through and do that massive cutscene thing, and then go back up the tower.
Yeah.
We can catch it again.
Pretty much.
It's fucking ridiculous.
Okay.
Alright.
So yeah, just to finish what I was saying, it's not even, like, if you're lucky and you have a regular life and you don't just, like, fucking live in a hole and play Pokemon all day, okay? Which most of you probably do. No offense. in all seriousness, If you want to make a team for every tier, okay, and you have to, like, breed all that shit, that will take you, like, a month and a half, okay? A month and a half of just non-stop Pokemon grinding. And then the tiers change, and your team gets fucked.
And you have to...
So we do all that again, you know? It's, like, it's just so stupid. And the people, like, come up to me, and they're like, oh, well, yeah, but you're hacking. It's like, no, I'm just... Oh, yes, I'm using a hacking software, but I'm just setting it up so that I could compete, you know? I'm not hacking shit, like, I'm not putting,
You're not making things illegitimate pokes. You're making legitimate pokes, but doing
you're
it in an illegitimate
making
way.
You're not making any sturdy shit ninjas.
I'm just cheating Lady Luck. That's all I'm doing. Just cheating Lady Luck. I mean, I don't have any freaking No Guard Deoxys speed with, like, Sheer Cold, okay? None of that. Just,
Sturdy Shedinja. Yeah.
You do have that, Bane. What are you talking about?
Yeah, like, no, but I have them. But, I mean, that's only to fuck around with the Battle Subway and screw with AJ, okay? It's like... not like, dude, the Battle Subway is so stupid, okay? Because they don't increase... I think I've already said this before, but they don't increase AI. The farther you get, the more hacked out you get. So, like, I think this is one Pokemon in there, and it's, like, a Walrein. And I think it's like Rest Talk with Fissure and Sheer Cold.
And it's every time.
Yeah, and if you get far enough, they just change it so that the Fissure and Sheer Cold is just 100% accuracy. It's stupid. They don't increase AI or anything. They just make it like.
Well, that's changed for Black and White 2.
Only after you beat the Elite Four.
There's a challenge mode. Want to speak about that? Let's talk about that while we're on the topic.
Challenge mode, yeah. Basically, they increase the AI. Have you played, like, it's like playing Fire Red Omega, because the guy that did Fire Red Omega actually increased the AI for it.
Yeah.
They've basically taken the way people have hacked games. They actually looked at that, at the hacked games, and the way people have increased the AI, and the ways they could do it. So to do that, they've kind of got to know it at least a tiny bit of competitive stance, and they've got to know how their game work, but, I mean, you say they've got to know how their game work, and they give Delibird three abilities that cancel out sleep, so...
Two, but still.
Two and then hustle, so... With present. Well done. Well done, Game Freak.
It's such a troll. It's like, how could anyone take that seriously? Present. I'm a freaking penguin with shitty stats who can't fall asleep. You know what I think they were doing? I don't even think it was trolling. I don't think the Japanese at Game Freak are even capable of trolling. I think it was more a case of,
oh, Delibird is like Elf from Santa Claus. And Elf never sleep. Elf is always working. So we give him two abilities that don't make him sleep.
That's Game Freak logic right there.
And then it got hustle. It got hustle because... They've realized that Christmas is actually a scam.
Yeah, because they gotta hurry up. No, they gotta hurry up and hustle.
No, because they've realized that Christmas is actually a scam, and they're being hustled.
See? Well, that wasn't mildly racist at all.
I don't care.
What do you mean mildly racist? That was definitely racist.
Okay, we are getting close to the 2-hour mark.
Yeah, but I told you this would be a long one. We haven't even finished. We've just finished our second topic.
We may have to split this in two, I don't know.
No, we're not. All in one.
No.
All in one.
People come back and actually like watch it in two sections, two sittings. I mean, I understand podcasts are big things to listen to, but that's why we would
you should find a spot in the podcast where like we sort of stop talking a bit and then insert like a really corny intermission.
Oh, okay, I'll record that.
Yeah. I'll do that.
Could it be like an advert for
an advert or just like a
This is like crazy Bob.
Yeah, like Microsoft Paint, just like, you know, sort of shifting around, saying it's a mission, and then just play like really shitty.
Diego's picture he drew me in Microsoft Paint 2 is pretty amazing.
This is a pretty good picture.
All right. Okay. So moving on. I think we covered pretty much everything in the.
So yeah. Now let's talk about this new segment we're going to start doing in our podcast from now on. It's predictions or like expectations that we'd like to see in Gen 6. We're not going to spend a whole lot on it. We're just going to give one to each person.
Bane already spoke about his poison thing.
Yeah.
Which is actually something that, if I'm honest, and if I actually had a sway at Game Freak, that would be... kind of an ideal thing because it kind of weakens water and strengthens poison. I think poison needs a buff and water needs a bit of a nerf, so I would go with that. But I'd like to see, along the lines of what Bane was saying, I'd like to see a really strong special attacking poison type in the next gen and like a really strong poison type move. Well, we've got sludge bomb, like a 120 base power poison type move.
You know what? When we get around to doing that ROM hack that we're working on, sort of a bit, when I finally get around to like finishing all that, it's probably gonna get around being done like next summer or something. I'm gonna have school and stuff, and I'm gonna be working and a bunch of stuff, and I probably won't have time to do it anytime this year. I might, but no promises. But I think that's something I want to implement. I want to make poison super effective against water and see how it just pans out. Just a little idea there.
Yeah, so I want to see a special attack, strong special attacking poison type with a 120 base power poison type, maybe like a thunder, hurricane thunder kind of thing.
Gunk shot? Mm-hmm. Oh, you mean a strong, yeah, okay. I also want a ghost attack like that. Like, because ghosts are like a physical, I don't know, I think I was talking about that at one point. I'm not sure exactly what it was, but it was like, it was something where it was like a very strong attack fire blast here, but for a maybe for bug or something, or no, bug already has mega horn. I think it was for ghost. It was like a strong ghost.
Yeah, ghost doesn't have one. The highest it's got is shadow ball, right?
Yeah,
I think it was a physical attack. It was like, oh no, it's shadow force, but I don't know, it was something like that. Okay, something, I don't quite remember exactly what it was, but it was just something that would make it better. But then again, if you think about that, imagine if Chandelure got that. Oof.
Chandelure's already going to Ubers anyway, so it doesn't even matter.
You know what I want to use? Look, this actually has nothing to do with Gen 6, but I just thought I'd throw it in there. Lampent, when Chandelure gets Shadow Tag, I want to use Lampent.
Dude, I'm already using Lampent.
No, but I mean Shadow Tag.
It's really good.
So I mean, look,
it's gonna
think about
Shadow Tag Lampent's probably gonna go. Are you?
But just think about this, okay? Choice banded, normal attack, or whatever, or you know, just a very shitty attack, like I don't know, a bug attack or something. Like a Moxycross, for instance, okay? Moxycross goes for Mega Horn. You switch in freaking Lampent with like full defense.
If I like Lampent.
Yeah. Something like that, okay? Mega Horn, as long as it doesn't have any Moxie boost, probably be doing like around 4 or 5% because it's quad resisted. You set up a sub, you set up 6 Calm Minds, and you sweep the rest of the team. You know, yeah. sort of the way it would work in general. You can do the same thing with Chandler, obviously, right? But, I don't know. I think Lampent would be more potent just because Chandelure would be in Ugras, where that kind of strategy would be less viable because no one really runs Banded Arceus Extreme Speed or anything. So,
the closest you can get to that is people using Scarf Terrakion.
Yeah. Well, like a fighting move. There, that's another one. A fighting
Blaziken.
Move or normal type. That's not like a hard...
Dude, Blaziken.
Yeah, Blaziken. Yeah. There. Of course, it doesn't get flash fire anymore, so it still gets hit by fire attacks, but...
Yeah, but it'll be resisted.
Yeah, it'll be resisted. And if you have Violite, max defense or something, resist very well. So, I don't know, it was just a curious thing I wanted to point out there. But anyway, Brock, what do you want it for Gen 6? Any idea?
Personally, I actually wanted this for Gen 5, and I was really pissed when I found out that Tepig was... and its evolved forms were going to be firefighting.
Oh my god, yeah, I know what you mean.
It just pissed me off so much. It bugged me a little bit when I found out Infernape was going to be firefighting, but I was able to tolerate because, like, look, it's a fucking monkey. That's awesome.
I think with that, though, everything counters each other.
Yeah.
In 4th gen, all the stars counted each other.
That's why it works. But my thing with... the fire types is I'm sick of seeing firefighting. It's been done too many times. Move on. Let's get a fire rock in.
I don't even know what pigs have to do with it. It's like the first time I saw the pig fire starter and they didn't get the types down, I was like, okay, this is cool. It's going to be like pig dark or something. And be like... No, I was thinking pig dark and like based around gluttony.
You mean fire dark?
Idiot. Pig dark type. But oh my god, so much dumb.
Just keep it away from the fire.
Okay.
Turns it into bacon.
It's gonna be bacon type. anyway, but fire. Yeah, sorry, brain, just making sure it works. fuck. fire dark type, and it would be like based around the fact that it's like a pig and it eats a lot and gluttony is a sin, and that's why I was sort of over analyzing it, but whatever.
Yeah.
Either that or like poison fire because pigs are stinky and they got like poison or I don't know something like that.
Yeah.
But fighting, I mean, do you know any fighting pigs?
I'm sure there's some school in the state.
Warthogs maybe, but. I don't know.
I'm sure there's some high school in the States that are firefighting.
I can remember an anime that had like a kung fu pig in it.
I think I remember that too.
Yeah, I can't remember what it was called, but I remember like a kung fu pig.
Okay, but I mean, come on. Like, other than that one anime with the kung fu pig, keep in mind I've seen, like, Tyki knows what I'm talking about. Animes don't make
sense. He can.
Oh my god, don't look that up, guys. Don't. It's spelled E-I-K-E-N. Don't look it up.
I'm going to spell it for you, but don't look it up.
Anyways, so yeah, what I've been waiting for is like a fire rock type. And I'm also... there is Mad Cargo, but...
Cargo is legit, dude. Don't hate.
I wanted to have the ability Rock Head. And I want it to get Flare Blitz and Head Smash.
That'd be like a dream world thing for it, wouldn't it, though?
Yeah, but here's the other thing. I also don't see what the use in having Blaze and...
Well, they've all had Blaze, Torrent, and Overgrow. Yeah.
I think it's time to change it up a bit.
I don't think you can change it.
They aren't going to change it because it's Nintendo, and they don't do that.
I don't think they should change it anyway.
I don't know, like, they're trying to shake things up with Gen 5 and move away from all the older stuff, so I think maybe changing up the abilities as well wouldn't be such a bad idea.
Well, that's what they've got Dream World, though, Brock.
Yeah. I think they something to do that through Dream World. I don't think they just outright get rid of Blaze Overgrow Torrent. That's sort of something that's stuck since the beginning, and I don't know, there's some sort of nostalgia factor attached to it, if you understand. I just don't think it's something they just changed right on the fly like that. But I would definitely love to see that as a...
Yeah, a Fire Rock with Flare Blitz, Head Smash. And then the last two moves, it doesn't really need any more moves. Like, yeah, you could give it Wild Charge for coverage, and then the last move, what are you going to put on it? Maybe like Quick Attack or Extreme Speed,
Double
I don't know.
Double Edge.
Frustration, whatever, doesn't matter. Like, it's just going to destroy, and you can give it a Life Orb or a Scarf or whatever.
That really pissed me off in Gen 4, and in Gen 5 again when Dreamworld came out, how Rampardos never got Rock Head despite being based on an animal, well, dinosaur, that is, like, known for its rock-like head, you know?
That, and the dinosaur used to fight other dinosaurs of the same species by headbutting each other, running at each other full force and headbutting each other.
And then on the other hand, you have fucking Bagon, who, like, God knows why the fuck that exists. Like,
Bagon, I'm a dragon with a rocky head and I have Rock Head.
It doesn't it only gets Double Edge or something.
Yeah, it's like, why would you even make that? Why does it exist? It's pointless.
Once again, troll freak.
I'm thinking it's less troll freak and more we don't have knowledge of fundamentals freak, you know?
They don't know their own metagame.
Yeah, they don't know what they're doing. I mean, they have, like, I think the only feedback they listen to is, like, the 12-year-old Japanese morons who play, like, VGC. So...
Hey, don't know VGC, okay?
Okay. Dude,
so...
Let's get to what you'd want to see in 6th gen.
Finishing off with you, Tyki.
Your turn to shine.
Okay. So there are a couple things I want to see, though. I think right now the thing I really want to see is a grass fire type with chlorophyll.
Ooh, yeah. I don't know. I'm going to have to stop. I don't know. Because what would that be weak to?
Rock. Flying. Poison.
It'd be weak to flying and poison. It wouldn't be weak to rock.
No, grass doesn't resist rock.
That's actually some pretty good typing right there, to be honest. Surprisingly.
It's amazing typing with chlorophyll and a sun boost.
It's amazing offensive typing with chlorophyll.
Look, I don't know. It would be a very good... like.
If it had... If it didn't have ridiculous stats...
Yeah, if it had, like... If it was sort of like a Ludicolo, you know? Where, it's good, but it's not so good that it's broken.
Or if it had, like, I don't know... Base 92 attack and special attack or something.
I think it would have growth automatically just because of grass type, but whatever.
Yeah.
Don't all grass types get growth anyway?
Yeah. Thing. Yeah. Give it like I don't know.
I say give it 100 attack and special attack. Give it shit defense.
See now, I'd say 100 attack and special attack with growth boost. That's just ridiculous.
Yeah. I was thinking more like.
Like 70.
70 attack, 85 special attack or something.
Yeah. Maybe
like 70 speed. Just make it like a relatively mediocre Pokemon that really comes out in the sun, you know?
Yeah.
That's what I would think.
Jumpluff or what's the other one called?
Jumpluff's really fast though. That's
the normal grass one. What's that one called?
Sawsbuck.
Sourcebook, that's amazing.
Sourcebook is a good attack, though.
Sourcebook is great.
Yeah.
Venusaur, though. Where would Venusaur be without Chlorophyll?
He'd be you.
Victory Bell. That actually comes out really good in the sun, and it's Enyu.
Venusaur also gets Aromatherapy, I think.
I don't think you can get it with Chlorophyll.
It used to be...
Yeah, I know, but I mean, if you didn't have Chlorophyll...
Before Chlorophyll, it used the Aromatherapy set.
Yeah, it would just sort of take the role of, like, sort of a cleric, like Valfum does, you know?
It has, like, what? Base 80 special defense, base 80 special defense, like... Is it base 83? No. Base 100 special defense and base 83 defense.
Yeah.
And base 80 HP. So it would be quite good specialty. It's quite a good specialty defensive wall.
I agree.
What is?
Venusaur.
I mean, like, compared to Vileplume, which isn't really that stellar either when it comes to stats, it's just the typing that really saves it.
I mean, come on, Ivysaur destroys.
Well, okay, look, let's not start talking about fucking Ivysaur again.
Yeah, we already spent enough time on Ivysaur.
Okay, things I want. Okay, well, no, Tyki, did you explain everything that you wanted in
Gen 6? I mean, like, there are other good typings, like Ghost Steel, Ghost Fighting, Ghost Normal, but...
Ghost Fighting is something I want.
I was thinking Ghost Normal, and it would be like a skeleton or something, or a zombie, or maybe a voodoo doll, something like that. I don't know.
Would Ghost Normal be weak to anything? No, it wouldn't, would it?
No.
Well, it would be...
Because Ghost wouldn't be able to
dark.
Hit.
Dark, yeah.
It would be dark. Mm.
Which is fine, you know? Which I mean, it would,
there's things that have no weaknesses.
Because then it's pursuit bait.
It's pursuit bait.
I don't know, I just think it would be interesting to play around with, because then you got, like, Stab Normal, which is pretty cool. I mean, it's not, like, all that useful, but it's still pretty cool, and then you got Stab Ghost. Mm-hmm. I think there's enough, like, bulky... I think the bulky Ghost-type role is sort of filled out. I mean, you got Spiritomb, you got Cofagrigus, and you got Dusclops, Dusknoir, stuff like that. You don't really need any more of those. But a nice little offensive Ghost-type that could just, like, I don't know, be UU or RU or something. Be cool.
Yeah.
Definitely would.
Other things that I want. Anything else you want, Tyki? Anything particular?
I think
all I really want typing wise. I mean,
can we just say if Flare Blitz Flareon is not out come the end of 6th gen,
dude, I'm fucking bombing Game Freaking.
Yeah, I will personally go to Game Freak with I'll a fucking with nuke strapped to
that shit.
And be like, 7th gen, this thing better be here, otherwise I'm going to blow myself up right here, right now. Take out all of Tokyo with me, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
I can't believe, since they got Flare Blitz, they've missed
out. The greater good.
Such a treat, giving Flareon Flare Blitz. I mean, it's in its fucking name.
Yeah.
Flareon Flare Blitz. It's 130 fucking base attack, man. It is begging for Flare Blitz.
Oh man, just use Flame Charge. What are you doing?
With guts as well.
Flame Charge.
Toxic
Flame Charge, dog.
One more thing I want in 6th gen, and that is, I want the rating of Pokemon to be at least T. At least T. I feel like right now they're way too goody-goody kids. Like, they need to be able to go darker.
Yeah, okay, so, like, it can make the story more interesting, too.
Isn't, like, Pokemon XD meant to be, like, the darker...
I know, but that's a spin-off. I want, like, the main games.
I don't think they could do that, you know. Because the thing is it all based... Pokemon's all based for... Actually, no, they should do that, because their main fan base now is, like, from, like, ages 13 up. Less good. Like when we started playing it was all kids. When we were young, they were all kids age from like 7 and 10 and that.
Not to mention if you don't forget that like they've also got the aging fan base. Like Pokemon's incredibly popular in a lot of high schools and college and stuff like that. It's not like their only demographic is kids now. It's still their largest demographic, I think. But I think
there's Frosty Pixie out there who's playing, and she's like, how old?
40 or something.
Yeah.
Hey!
Guys, let's not bash people that are not in the PFC.
Let's get one thing clear. I don't give a fuck about Frosty Pixie. I don't care about that fat bitch. I don't care about her channel. Frosty Pixie fanboys, come at me. I don't give a fuck. You're a bunch of losers, okay?
Like, I'll be editing that part out.
No, you are not editing that part out, okay? Because there's one thing that I really enjoy about the PFC, and that is that we have fucking balls, and we don't bend to political correctness bullshit. We don't go around calling people N-words and being dicks and stuff like that, okay? But, you know, if we just...
Paul.
Yeah, we're not the channel who's going to sell out, okay? We're not going to sell out just because, like, look, if I hate Wild Chase, I'm allowed to hate Wild Chase. I don't give a fuck, okay?
And we can all collectively say we hate Pimp Knight as well.
Yeah,
Yeah. Okay.
Like, well, we wouldn't piss on Pimp Knight, on fire.
Pimp Knight's one thing. That's Pimp Knight. He's just a whore.
An Australian bastard. Anyway.
Yeah.
Okay. So any. Okay. Yeah, so
he has an rating? Epic Beldum sweep. I mean.
What?
I don't even know. Continue, Bane.
I don't know what you're talking about. Beldum sweep. Anyway. Takedown. I think I sort of see you. Never mind.
Yeah. So Bane has two personalities. He has his intelligent personality where he's talking about shit. And then he has his rage mode personality. Like, if you haven't noticed.
No. Oh, I'm going to stop you there.
That wasn't my rage mode personality.
Personally, yeah, first of all, you've obviously never seen Bane rage if you think that's him raging. And
yeah,
second,
true.
It is intelligent because as a group, we honestly, between us, we don't give a fuck what we say to each other. Because
yeah.
We're friends anyway. Like, it's even got to the point where we've started poking jokes at Crispy now when he's been around, and he's like brand new to the group.
And I think he's cool with it. And if he has a problem with it, if it really bothers him, okay, then we'll stop because we're not.
Yeah, I am gay.
Okay.
Wait, sorry. What was that?
Finally, he came out of the closet for fuck's sake.
Okay. Anyway.
Oh my the line. God.
Yeah, fucking asshole. Just, he interrupts people and then, like...
Come on. Well, hey, at least this time he interrupted people for the betterment of himself.
Yeah.
Are you going to share your Facebook with us now to show us what your boyfriend looks
okay.
like?
Okay. Can we please just let me finish it? Anyway.
Yes.
As I was saying, okay, look, if you want to... Okay, this is how Bane functions, okay? I hate most people by default just because most people are fucking morons, okay? That means if you're acting like a moron and I don't know you, odds are I hate you, okay? However, if you're nice to me, even if you're a moron, I don't care. I'll reciprocate. I'll be nice back. That's just the way I am. If you're a good person and you're not a moron, then I'm still going to find some way to find a problem with you. But, you know, after getting to know you, sort of, then I'll like you. It's cool.
I have an eyelash in my eye.
Make a wish. Make a wish.
Really hurts.
Make a wish. Make a wish. Wish the eyelash to get away.
You could say
wish
right
the
now.
Eyelash away.
It's still in my eye.
It's like a xenomorph. It's not actually an eyelash. It's like in Prometheus. You guys saw that where the
my eyes actually turning itself inside out. It's like Pan's Labyrinth.
anything else?
Anyway, we were talking about. What were we talking about?
We just actually finished getting Tyki's 6th gen, what he wants in 6th gen.
That's true.
Which means that we now need to move on to the almost last topic.
Bane.
Yeah, I just want to point something out.
Because Bane did say his thing. Bane.
Okay, say your thing.
Thank you.
Jesus. Bane.
There are a few things that I want. One, I want Farfetch to get him. I want a bunch of evolutions to come out.
I'm pretty sure you've already said this during this podcast.
No, I think
before the podcast.
Before the podcast.
Oh.
But what I want is I want the fucking I want new evolutions. Like I talked about the pincer evolution. That's one thing that really disappointed me with 5th gen. I understand that they wanted to just focus mainly on new Pokemon, but one thing that I really enjoyed about 4th gen was when the Unveiling came out and it was sort of like lurking around CeraVe and I was like, oh look, this is cool. And, you know, everyone got trolled by Shellos that everyone thought was Lapras' pre-Evo, but it actually wasn't. You know, just stuff like that. And
Evar.
Yeah, seeing, like, evolutions. And I really enjoyed seeing evolutions, and I was like, oh, cool, this is great, evolutions, right? And I'm always excited to see more evolutions. I understand that some of that, like, might be a problem because, like, if Weezing got an evolution, the Violet Weezing, GG. But,
God.
Yeah, but, you know,
yeah, but then again, it Violet Duskops, so...
Yeah, there you go.
Okay,
so,
Violet Skarmory. Fuck you.
Yeah, that would never be.
Is that Weezing doesn't have like 30 base HP, so it's a bit more threatening than a Violet Dusclops. It would be actually. I'm probably gonna do the calculator. I'm not gonna do it now. We have enough stuff. But that's one thing that I wanted. Another thing that I wanted. I wanted cast forms to get stat boosts.
Ooh yeah.
Yeah.
I think that would be really cool.
And one for. Doesn't there need to be one for hail and sandstorm?
Yeah, there's already one for hail, I think.
where, like, yeah, there's one for Hail, but I want one for Sand. That would be really cool, too. Add another Castform form, and in celebration of the new Castform form, boost those stats. And, you know, maybe not even boost that much, but...
Give him stab.
He's got, like, base 70, I think, in every set. Just make, like...
Give it stab. That's what you need to say.
Yeah, give two of them, like, base 90 or something, or, you know, make it at least viable in fucking NU or something. But, you know, just something, just sort of like a little type boosty thing. Make a rain cast form more bulky or something. I don't know, just be creative, go crazy. So that's another thing that I wanted. I already mentioned the poison type thing, and last but not least, we were sort of talking about this before the call, and imagine a fighting flying type that's the evolution of Farfetch, and it's basically like sort of a really cool looking duck with like a bow staff. Think about that.
So cool.
Alright.
Yeah, okay, Brock.
So yeah, we spent more time on that than I was hoping we would, but anyways, yeah. I'm gonna go all PMS right now. No. Jokes.
You're gonna cry in your pony plushie.
Yeah. Hey, I'm still waiting on them. They haven't delivered them yet.
Whoa.
You struck those, bring them to your house.
I was just joking.
You actually bought pony plushies.
No.
Could you imagine being the delivery guy? Handing them over to like a grown man.
What if the delivery guy was also a brony, and then you like you invite him in and you spend like half an hour playing Tea Party pony?
Okay, that's enough about ponies. No, so we've broken the 2-hour mark.
Yeah,
thought we should have a round of applause for that. Yay! So last topic, Cliff, you said you had an announcement about the PU tournament.
This isn't the last topic, because we've still got one more thing to talk about after this. But, the PU tournament, guys, just a quick update, get your battles done. You've got till the 22nd, right, Bane?
Yarg, sir.
Around the 22nd, at least. And to the people that are in the loser's bracket, you need to do 2 battles. In this round, so, and like I think only 2 of the losers bracket battles had actually been done by the last time I checked the tier list. So, get on that, guys, because you're the guys that are slowing down
the bracket. Yeah.
Yeah, you
and
guys.
Look, I got a couple complaints last time because of the coin flips, and people were like, "Oh, how come I got coin flipped and I didn't go through?" This is what happens when you don't battle. Like, you know, if you're like a bit laissez-faire and you sort of you like let it slide and then you get coin flipped and you get eliminated, but you're like, oh, but I was more active. Well, if you're more active, then why didn't you tell me that you were more active than
yeah, why if you're active, post activity posts
or you know just something, you just PM
or
me
message
on.
You message us on YouTube or something, so you know
just we are here. Dr. Seuss reference right there.
I got it, don't worry.
Just do something like that, just to make sure that that we know you're here, and emphasize your presence a little, because otherwise I can't really do anything. I can't change the brackets, because then the other guy's gonna be like, well, what is this bullshit? You know, it's kind of a touchy thing to deal with. That's it. Cliff, anything else you want to add to this?
Just guys in the losers bracket. You're the guys that's slowing us down at the moment. I think we need like 2 more battles from the winners bracket, and then the winners bracket is, you know, almost done, and then it's like 7 more battles.
Yeah.
In the losers bracket. So.
Trying to dethrone me, guys. Make that your motivation. I want to make Bane like eat my dick.
Yeah. If you're in the losers bracket and Bane's already beat you, make it your sole purpose to try and get
to annihilate.
See, the thing is, you're talking. You've got to play me in the next round.
I'll just pick a hard counter for Ivysaur, and it's guaranteed.
Bane, I would just like to point out we have Tyki in the call. You might want to refrain from making any dick eating references.
No. We have to.
Not you just being an asshole. No,
Tyki, I'm sorry. I forgot. We were talking about the PU tournament. You got eliminated, didn't you, Tyki?
Silence ensues.
Tyki, you were like the first person to get eliminated legitimately.
He's just, like, slowly seething right now. He's like, I'll get you, Tom.
Is he...
Not today, not tomorrow, but one day.
What are you going to do, Tyki? Stick your dick in my mouth.
Okay, let's...
You'd well, like that, okay. Wouldn't you?
Oh, yeah, babe.
Oh, snap. Doing the Z-shaped... yeah.
Oh, anyway. No, you didn't.
Oh, no, you did. Bitch, please.
All right. Last two little things we'll do here really quick. The PFC server, it is up 24/7 now, or pretty close to, right, Cliff?
Thank you, Cliff.
We do have Smogon tiers, and I think we're getting PO tiers as well.
Nope.
Yeah,
we're
not getting PO tiers, but we're getting what we are gonna get is like I want to try and sort of put like a monotype, monocolor, just like sub tiers like that.
Yeah.
People can enjoy that as well. Try and get some sort of like ladder or something. But it's not going to be stupid. Like, we're going to have sleep claws and stuff.
We're going to do gens 5 through 1 before we start worrying about.
Yeah. I'm aware of this, but. It's going to be up. I think Cliff has to go to America. Well, he doesn't have to, but he's going to America. The United States of America. He's going there for. On the 30th, I believe, or something like that.
Yeah, for 4 weeks.
Yes, for 4 weeks? Shit, that's a long time. So I'm going to try and host the PFC server as much as I can, because Croak's gone. Or, I don't know, we're going to figure something out.
Yeah, where is Bill, anyway?
Went on vacation. I don't know, he went to Turkey, then he went on vacation.
On Turkey to get his foreskin removed, and then went on vacation. I'm sorry if you didn't want people to know that, Croak, but...
Wait, did you really?
Yeah, no lie. He went to Turkey to get his foreskin removed because it was actually cheaper to fly to Turkey, get it done there, than it would have been to actually get it done in America.
I really don't think yours was the
choice. Why did he even bother doing it? Like, fuck, either have it... Like, if my parents didn't do it to me when I was a baby, I would have never even bothered doing it. Like, fuck it.
Oh, dude, sometimes people have, like, medical conditions where they need it to happen.
Like,
yeah,
what?
Like, that's the only
way. Like, I don't know. I'm not a foreskin
want to
doctor,
get,
okay?
Like...
Jukru.
Thank you.
Jukru.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just wondering, who would want to get their dick, like...
It's you in the stern or something? No.
Operated on, like, fuck.
Hey, we have cleaner penises. Can I just say that?
No, look. That's false because there's also manual cleaning. Just FYI, it's something you can do in the shower.
We don't need to manual clean. We don't need to pull down foreskin.
Think about this. Okay. As a foreskin dude, okay, those things are practical. Those things are practical as hell. Okay?
Have fun with your turtleneck. That's all I can say.
I might have to make a bloopers.
Let's like slow it down here. But anyway, so I'm gonna try and host it as much as I can. No foreskin Croak is gonna try and host it too if he comes back.
When he comes back, he said he's gonna host it permanently.
Yeah, when he comes back, he's gonna host it permanently. So it's gonna be up 24/7. He can just do whatever the fuck he wants. It's all right, all good. Until then, I can't guarantee that I can have it up for the full 4 weeks, just because my dad has a tendency of like not seeing my internet away. However, if I'm working. Odds are he's not going to do that because I'm just going to say, what the fuck are you doing? So, and I'm probably going to
I can also help out with that too.
Yeah,
so.
And we can sort of like flip flop between Brock and I.
Which means server IP is going to be changing a bit until at least I come back or Croak comes back.
Yeah, but you know, even if you don't even need the IP, I mean, you can sort of just scroll down the server list and like just see where it is. It's always going to be named the Poco Pike Club, so don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Anything else?
So aside from that, that's everything we have for this stream today, guys.
Stream?
Fuck.
We're actually streaming this.
Yeah, we're streaming this. Surprise.
We're going to stream the next one, yeah.
Yeah.
The next Hitmonchat is going to be streamed, so we're going to tell you guys, and you can like listen in, and we can ask you guys questions in the chat and stuff like that. It's going to be cool.
Yeah. that's it for this.
Oh, Tyki, you were meant to be in that one, weren't you?
Which one?
The next one.
Yeah.
Looks like you're not anymore.
Nope.
Unless you want to.
Well,
foreskins, it'll be great.
Yeah, we'll talk about foreskins some more.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's good.
Practical foreskins.
Dude, they're not practical at all.
They really are. You just don't know because you like grew up dickless, so...
Whoa. Right. I think Kate can confirm that.
Okay,
I'm dickless.
Can we wait like 5 minutes and we'll finish this up and then we can talk about dicks more later?
Okay, that's great. So I'll finish
okay.
it up. Finish it up.
So, yeah.
This is coming from the guy who, like, we were unable to start one of the podcasts because him and a certain jarhead...
kept saying the N-word
nonstop when we were trying to start the podcast, and now you have the audacity to try and keep us on track.
Actually, I changed like halfway through the amount of attempts that it took for us to start that podcast to actually try and start it.
And then it was everyone else started. Who lost the last Hitmonchat after we spent like an hour and a half recording it.
My Camtasia's been fucked for like the last week.
Okay, whatever.
Anyways,
I'm gonna sign this off right now before this gets too ridiculous.
I just want to get a quick announcement in. So yeah, that's it for today, everyone. We are gonna be streaming. I believe we're uploading this on the Saturday, so it'll be Saturday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I think you're going to be hosting that, right, Cliff?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because everybody else's internet is shit, so I'm going to be hosting the server and the stream at the same time.
I'm actually going to be there for Saturday. I'm going to be going back from a camping trip then, so it's going to be
cool. Nice. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. Stay tuned for the next episode of Hitmonchat, and be sure to leave a like, comment, and if you haven't subscribed yet... be sure to do that.
Can I just add something?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, I'm done.
Go ahead. Okay.
What
did you say? I think Tyki needs to talk. Tyki.
I'm done.
Okay. Yeah. Check out our Facebook page.
Oh, I think
Bane
needs to say something.
Oh, fuck you, Tom. All right, we're ending this here. Because it's been really long.
All right.
Anyways, I'm Soulfate. I'm here with Cliff, Bane, and Tyki, and we're signing out until next time. Peace out.
Bye.
Bye.
See you later.